Neil.
You gave away 500 tickets?
Yeah, and 500 people total were at that game. It was a ghost town, a funeral house. It was a freaking morgue. It was a mausoleum.
10,213.
My ass.
Everything you need to know. Have you finally taken the South Florida cure? Have you got?
I finally eaten duck soup. If there was 500 people there yesterday, if there was 10,000, I'll blow every one of them.
Right.
There's no way.
There's a line at the door.
There is a.
Clarence
there was 500
is the first
people.
Line, by the way, he wasn't even at the game.
I drank so many Budweiser or so many Heinekens that I was seeing double.
Speaking of the Beast took care of him, how come the Beast is doing live spots on your show? A high-priced talent like you who can't even afford a car.
Yeah.
How come the Beast is doing live spots?
I can afford a car. I just won't pay for one. I got a car deal, supposedly. I'll believe it when I see it. And the
right.
Beast, I'm giving him real estate. I charge him $5 to do a live read.
No, seriously, what kind of crap is that? You're only on for 2 hours. You have limited avail.
Right.
And this little tub of crap that you're on the verge of blowing out of there anyways doing live spots.
Yeah, I'm going to bring that up to Greg Reed in my next meeting with him.
Yeah?
It's just a very valid point. Why am I letting the Beast use my avails?
Yeah, you
Sorry.
Notice how he did it. He does it good on your show. When we asked him to do it yesterday on my show, he was he wasn't getting paid
for
it. Like
I got something in my mouth or something.
Yeah, I'm sure you did. That's what Clarence said.
You're marble boy.
So Clarence was offered two jobs. Are you aware of that?
No.
No.
One in Tennessee, one in Kentucky. Is PD. He said he prefers KY. And we got two polls today. Speaking of that, we got two slippery polls. We're taking an early poll to see if who should be fired at the station.
Yeah, who is?
And guess whose name I got on top of the list?
Beast.
Hola, this is Beast.
Good guess.
I love eating nuts.
What did you just say?
I do.
Are you getting defensive already?
No, I'm fine.
Well, your name just happened to be at the top of the list,
well,
since Ferrall's trying to get you blown out.
That's fine.
Yeah, I think that, you know, everything you say about,
at least Ferrall and Howard want somebody in common.
Hey, listen, I'm looking at the Sun Sentinel website yesterday afternoon. Oh, Dolphin game won't be blacked out. They finally sold out. I mean, what are we talking about? This is a town, especially in the summertime and all the way till December. Forget about summer. All the way through the fall, there's nobody there. They can't support anything. If you gave them like a gigantic jockstrap, they couldn't support it.
I went to I did Roy's last night for the first pro football game, and there was, I think, three guys
you
from Brooklyn
Roy's
there.
You had Roy's last night?
I wish I did.
Yeah.
Hey now, I love getting
rid
of them.
With the Beast long enough, you'll have roids.
Those things are like parasites. Those hemorrhoids.
You know, Roy Foster, who used to work in our sales department. He had bleeding, oozing hemorrhoids.
Oh, my God.
Did you know that?
No, but I do now.
Probably from that big strap-on that he used to borrow all the time. Whoa! Remember, okay,
that thing, that huge black dong.
Wow. That thing was dangerous.
God, I bet you, I won't even say what I think.
You didn't touch that thing, did you? Because Scran's been on it, near it, and around it.
Ah! Just thinking about that makes me go eat Tony Romas.
Oh, 10,213, and you were pumping it. Listen, even I, who don't give a crap about baseball anymore, even I was like pushing, come on,
listen,
just go out there and support the team. They're like tied for the wild card league. Nobody shows
up. I was
up.
In
we
right field.
They can't blame us at no
I was moment. In right field, and I yelled, hey, batter, swing, and you could hear me at home plate.
I'm sure of it.
It's embarrassing.
I could hear you on the air. I was listening to the game. I said, that's Ferrall in right field.
It was embarrassing, dude.
Wow, what are we going to do about this?
I'm just going to go and I'll go to Ole Ole tonight, I guess.
And you wonder why the hell I don't want to be there? You wonder why I stay out of there?
I know now.
Bad news, Scott, the only bad news is my phone rang. Well, I wasn't here, thank goodness. But I came back last night and there was a voicemail on my phone. Guess who it was from?
Roy.
Come on. It was from the stalker, Jeff Rimmer, your close personal friend, Jeff Rimmer. They're here now.
Oh, Jesus. Now,
they're
listen, here. I don't have any, your words of wisdom now are soaking in. I don't question authority anymore.
Yeah.
Stay you're right about everything. Him. I'm going to go back to Bogotica and jump in the pool. Good luck to you.
Excellent.
Have a great weekend, Scott.
You too.
Celia Cruz and I am dead now, but I remember when I was alive. I will let it do the new one. I want to do
it's Friday, you bastards.
TV and radio are totally in control with lies and misinformation.
Yes.
They don't want you to know about the globalist assholes bankrupting the whole damn nation. The economy took a crack, getting slaughtered in Iraq by the first dictator traitors. For the few that want to know, there's only one way to go. You gotta read 10 newspapers, but nobody cares about nothing.
No.
Yeah, nobody. They just wanna be in front of that TV, thinking what happens to them
ain't gonna be happening to me. No, but it cares about the man. Only after it's too late. Yeah, then they say, what did you say? But they were never gonna believe ya anyway. Don't bother me with too much information. I don't wanna read it. I don't wanna believe it. Don't confuse me with the facts. I'm getting it fair and balanced, say the mentally challenged. Believe all the spew in Fox News, they don't lie. No, but it cares about everything's just fine. So what if few people died? I can't be concerned with that. I'm busy picking seeds out my ass. Now don't say I didn't want you. Just take a look at California. And you got Florida with some, oh yeah.
10,213 at the Marlin game yesterday afternoon, tied for the wild card lead. They're now 12 games over 500. They're hot as a pistol. They're doing all of this without Mike Lowell now, last a few days. And nobody cares. That's why I played that right off the bat. Nobody gives a crap about anything. No mo.
Right. What?
Exactly. That's my point. Steve and George, you don't care. Hey, let's get to this first poll, so I have to give yesterday's poll results real quick. Let's dispense with that guy on six. Here's a Fort Lauderdale. Hello. Fort Lauderdale. Come on, let's do it. Yeah.
First guy that should get fired is you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And?
So do it.
Okay, do it. Do it.
You got.
Ted Koppel, by the way, was called in yesterday. What? What do you say there at the end?
I don't know.
Some jackass. First guy, by the way, thanks again for listening to the number one rated Neil Rogers show on the highly rated QAM, you asshole. Who's the most boring big name celebrity we asked yesterday? Don Imus wins by such a landslide. 189 votes out of 1,120. I mean, he was like more than double, just a little more than double his next closest competitor, Ben Affleck, 92. Rush Limbaugh, that big bag of wind, right-wing crap, 85. That was probably a Bush leaguer, leaguer that we just hit on there. Dr. Phil McGraw, who was a late addition, and thanks very much to the guy that called in at the end of the show yesterday, 70 votes, a strong fort. Harrison Ford, 61. Kevin Costner, 58, Howard Stern, 53, Charles Grodin and Richard Gere tied 44, Larry King, 41. Nice going, Larry.
Uh-huh.
Rosie O'Donnell, 37, Gloria Estefan and Carson Daly, 33, George Clooney, 31. See, now that call that I just had, that's typical of South Florida.
Sure.
It's not like, hey, good morning, Neil, understand the weather's beautiful there, have a nice weekend, everything going great for you. You know, no, it's like, you should be fired, retire, you know, a bunch of assholes. That's why nobody's there. George Clooney, 31, Woody Allen, 29, Keanu Reeves, 29, Lisa Marie Presley, that little dyke, 27, Jeff Goldblum, gross, 25, I wish he'd fly away, Ben Stein, 21, Ellen DeGeneres, 16, right on top of David Duchovny, 15, Arnold Schwarzenegger's got 11 in California, Phil Henry, 11.
Are you sure?
Checked it twice, Phil. Jay Leno, 11, Mariah Carey, 10, Steven Seagal, 9, Sly Stallone, 8, Edward James almost made the second page with 5, John Revolta, 5. Timothy Dalton, 4. Ben Stiller, 4. Denzel Washington, 3. Donald Sutherland only had 2 because they thought it was very exciting when he went, like that. Anthony Hopkins, 2. And Sean Connery had 2. So that's it. That was pretty good. I like that poll. And we're taking two polls today. First, a quickie this hour. If you could get one person fired at WQM, who would it be? And here's the list we got so far. Now, maybe we... Oh, by the way, the Panthers got another stiff, Jonas Hoglund, unloaded by the Leafs here. He's a stiff. So they got an old ex-Leaf, Todd Gill, Todd, no relation to Todd Dreck, and Jonas Hoglund. It's going to be a long season, Panther fans. Joni Hoglund. Boy, is she suck or what? If you could get one person fired at WQM, who would it be? Here's our list so far. The Beast, George, Neil, Mo Howard Davidson.
Absolutely.
Ferrall, Geldy, Greg Reed, Hank Goldberg, The Humper, Joe Costello, Mark Eisenberg, Orlando Elsequiri, and Jim Mandich. We left off Ed Kaplan because I don't have the heart to put him on here because there's no way he ought to get fired. I mean, no way any of these people should get fired. I'm not big into people getting fired just because somebody feels like it. And the reason I'm taking this preliminary poll is because Ferrall wants the Beast fired bad. Who already got blown off of the Mo Howard Davidson show.
Well, not fired, just off that show.
He wants him reassigned.
Right.
But that's no fun. I mean, seriously, can you imagine doing a poll? Who at WQM should be reassigned?
Nah.
You know what I mean? what are we talking about? That's not the South Florida effing way.
No, that would be gay.
the South Florida FMA is, fire your ass. You should be fired, Neil. You should retire. And, George, you suck. You know.
No, bro, yeah, no.
Bunch of unfriendly, nasty, miserable, hateful, rotten bastards is what you got in South Florida, which is why nobody can show up for anything, ball games. That's why they almost had a blackout. Can you imagine the opening, the home opener for the Dolphins, even though it's against a girls' team, blacked out? Can you imagine that, how embarrassing that would be?
No.
So they had to go right down to the wire to sell the last ticket so they could lift the blackout and declare it a sellout. And the Marlins, 10,213, and like Scott said, there were like maybe, you know, maybe a couple of thousand people. There was nobody there. Nobody there. They're red hot. They're on fire. They're like the shock of the sports world, at least in baseball, and nobody cares. Nobody's there. So why the hell should we be all bent out of shape? Huh? Nothing. We're doing the best we can.
About what?
About life in general. So let's get that new poll up there, Eric. Let's we'll keep this one on at 11:30, and then we got that second poll, which is similar.
Sure.
You notice the similarity there?
I did.
But it's much broader scope, and more fun. Hey, listen, when you got up this morning and took a deep breath, what were you breathing? If you're tired of the schmutz, the mold spores, the dust particles, and all the other crap in your air, maybe you got a really bad mold problem, you ought to call 1-866-542-4995. That's the number 4, Clean Air Restoration. These guys really know how to get your air clean. If you have respiratory problems or allergies, call 1-866-542-4995 today. You spent hundreds of thousands of dollars on your home, but not a penny to ensure that the air that you and your family and even your pets and your goldfish are breathing is clean. The air filter system on your air conditioning system is there to protect the AC coils. It's not intended to filter the air that you're breathing. Their HEPA-filtered air handling systems take out almost all airborne particulate, including all sorts of nasty things, mold spores that can potentially produce mycotoxins, animal dander, dust mites, insecticide yeast, yeast cells, skin flakes, building material dust. It gets my dander up just thinking about all the crap we're inhaling every day. Clean Air Restoration is licensed and insured. Their employees have been in the business for over 25 years. Right now, Clean Air Restoration has a special Neil deal for you. For just $19.95, they'll conduct a visual mold assessment of your house. They'll inspect your AC unit, AC air ducts, your home interior, and attic, too. From there, they can suggest what you may need to make the air in your home cleaner and safer. Clean Air Restoration handles mold-related insurance claims, commercial and residential projects as well. So improve the quality of your life by improving the quality of the air you're breathing every second of every day. Call now, 1-866-542-4995. Clean Air Restoration will make your air fit to breathe. That's 1-866-542-4995.
My and local. This is Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Who's going to give Ricky a blow?
Hello, everyone. Billy Mays here, the guy who brought you OxyClean and Orange Clean. Now I've got a new product that harnesses another all-natural cleanser. Introducing Feces Clean. Look at that red wine stain on this carpet. Think you have to throw it out? Think again. Just a few squirts of Feces Clean. And look at that! Now you won't even care about the wine stain! And Feces Clean even turns the carpet back to its original color, as long as it was brown. Let's put Feces Clean to work on this iodine stain! The patented brown foaming action and the distinctive odor is how you know Feces Clean is working. Now, just wipe it away with a crumpled piece of this 2-ply wiping tissue free with your purchase. Take it from me. I should know. I'm Billy Mays. My initials are BM. And Feces Clean works everywhere. Your home, office, garage, boat, or RV. Any place accidents happen. It even works on pesky chocolate stains and stubborn skid marks. I'm Billy Mays. Telling you that when stains gotta go, you gotta go with Feces Clean. Odor now.
10:18 at 560 WQM. Happy Friday to you. And we left a very important category off this initial poll. You realize that?
Nope.
Don't fire nobody.
Oh, that's right.
That's how I want to word it, Eric. Don't fire nobody. No, there are people who are real happy. You know, how many of you think are happy?
About 30, man.
Yeah, but don't want to see anybody get canned. I don't like people getting fired.
No.
Even Mo, although I did vote for him, but even Mo, I would like seeing him get fired. I'd like to see him like get reassigned, like maybe to Topeka or something like that,
yeah.
Or Ypsilanti.
But
fired is like, you know, just like when he tried to get your ass fired. You know, it's brutal. You start playing with people's lives.
Right. Cruel. Heartless.
Cruel, obnoxious, disgusting, unacceptable. So let's add that on there. Don't fire nobody. Here's a call from Moral Gables. Hello.
Retire, Jack.
Oh, retire,
oh,
you
wow.
Jackass. Retire.
Vim and Vigor.
I beg your pardon?
Vim and Vigor this time.
Right. That was good. That was a good one, pal. Here's Oakland Park. Hello.
I'd like to put my vote in for the Whisperer. Hello?
Which means what?
George, when he whispers, when that guy calls in, he goes, it's Reverend Jones.
No, you mean the mumbler.
No, he goes, it's Reverend Jones. Reverend Jones.
Oh, it's Reverend Jones again. That's another asshole. So there's three out of three assholes. We're batting 1,000.
Oh!
Even Ty Cobb couldn't do that. Even Baby Ruth couldn't bat 1,000. It's going to be Asshole Friday, and you know what? We're prepared for it. I'm delighted. I'm ecstatic. At least there's a pulse, you know what I'm saying? Tom Jicka says I can't. Oh, by the way, how many years since Tom Jicka wrote a column in the Sun Sentinel?
About 30, man.
Yeah. The last column on the website, July 29. This last time I checked is the 5th of September, so we kind of missed a month in there, and that's on the heels of his big whining and dining out in L.A. with all the big Hollywood TV moguls, you know? But I'm the one that's supposed to be out of touch. Touch this, Tom, you little jackass, you little squirt. Maybe he died or something. You think he died?
I don't
Greg
know.
And Sunrise, don't respond to that. We don't wish he would die. I mean, maybe like have...
Dye his hair.
That would be good if he had any. 3 to 5 this afternoon, the lovely Miguel, who's got plenty of hair, he'd like to show you some of it. He'll be at the Coconut Creek Seminole Casino, 5550 Northwest 40th Street, just off Sample Road, west of the Turnpike, in prestigious, very geriatric Coconut Creek, with our best in meal merchandise and a QM van. 3 to 5 this afternoon. We better plug that a lot, because I have a feeling. We had 19,400 as of the start of the show yesterday, and we're just not getting no information. If Doreen would keep her goddamn hands off of his ass, maybe he'd have some time to really get involved in this thing heavy duty, you know what I'm saying? But she is back there, like, grabbing his ass and trying to, squeeze his privates and sticking her tongue down his throat. That sounds like sexual harassment to me, don't it?
Okay.
Damn bitch. Anyway, Greg in Sunrise says, hi, Neil. I'm a fellow DNH devotee. Do no harm. Thank you. God bless you. First, thanks for the entertainment. Thanks for your commenting about the Beast being way too visible on the Ferrall Show. I sent an email to Duff informed him I've started to tune out whenever the Beast interrupts and talks over Scott. Finally, can you imagine the radio station would have if they had Scott and Mandy to do the Dolphin games? I said yesterday that Ferrall ought to be doing the Marlin games with Boog.
Right.
And I'm serious about that. Would be great.
As the colored guy?
He could be the colored guy. It says it would be outrageous, Scott and Mandich. Could you please play a Mandich yell and Scott screaming, woo, simultaneously? Greg and Sunrise has worked up into a frenzy. Mo Howard David's leading the early returns, and if one person was fired at QAM, who should it be? We got 28 votes. Come on, you can hop on here. We don't have a lot of time for this. Let's go! Mo Howard David at 14, the Beast 4, Geldy 2, 1 for Mandich, 1 for George, 1 for me, 1 for Scott, 1 for Greg Reed, 1 for the Humper, and now it's, look at that, Mo's up to 20 votes. How do you like that?
Absolutely.
I think he's a wiener. Here's Delray Beach. Hello.
Mo and Beast ought to be on from 2 to 5 or whatever. They're the worst on the air, so put those two together, make them live with each other, they're miserable bastards.
Okay, thanks. 5670560, pound 560 on the ATs. What did I tell you? This is the kind of stuff.
Yep.
This is the meat and potatoes of South Florida. This is why nobody comes back unless they absolutely have to be there. The guy that called a couple of days ago, that would be a good poll question. Why do you come back? It's a no-brainer.
Gravity.
Because they have to. They have no choice. There could be no other reason. No other reason. And this is part of the problem, is try to support anything in a horse and buggy seasonal town. I don't care how many millions of people they claim live there. They're just a few people, it's the old wet foot, dry foot, light foot. Remember Gordon Lightfoot?
Yeah, how's he
That's
doing?
That's what it's all about. Here's Miami, hello. Oh, he's starting a new deal now, that guy. Here's Miami on 4, hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, sir, Big Don.
Yeah.
Neil up from the Jamaica Posse, Neil,
What language you speaking, man?
Jamaican.
Jamaican, huh?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, what can you do
Neil,
for it? Say something.
Neil, if it was up to me, man, I'd have fired Howard. But since you said to take it easy on Howard, I say I'd give him a 3 p.m. to 3:15 show and have him be the sideline reporter for our middle school. Yeah,
All right. You got his number, George?
Oh, yeah.
Sounds like he's got the good crap. Okay, now we're getting going on this, aren't we? No. Mo Howard David leading, of course. What a concept. George and I both voted for Mo. Mo's got 26 votes. Well, I saw there was only two votes on there in the beginning. They were both ours. The Beast 8, Don't Fire Nobody 7. We like those 7 people. They appreciate the fact that we need to eat, okay? George 5, Greg Reed 5, Neil 3. Fire Neil. Ferrall 3. 2 for Geldy. Orlando Alzaquiri's got 2. Jim Mandich has got a pair. Boy, the people are really surly because Mad Dog never gets any negatory votes. You know what?
Right.
There ain't nobody don't like the Mad Dog. He's got a pair already. Joe Costello's got one. Humphrey's got one. None for Mark Eisenberg out of 65 because nobody has any idea who he is. He's a good guy. He's just terrible on the air. Here's Pompano. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, a couple things for you. George should be fired.
Yeah.
And I got a question for you. You said City TV is really good.
Yeah.
Well, I went on online the other day. I checked out City TV. All it is American Broadcasting.
No, it's not. I'm not talking about any of the network, American network shows they carry. Why, you have no idea what you're talking about, you idiot. You parochial imbecile. He went online. Yeah, what does that mean? You watching City TV online?
No.
No. Here's a guy that he's critiquing for me, television in Toronto because he's looking at some crap online, a listing of network shows that they might carry. What does that have to do with anything? With the price of peanuts? Anything?
No.
Nothing. There's one of your people, one of your negatory people.
Yeah.
It goes to show you. The people that hate George, generally speaking, don't know Schmidt. Although some of them are pretty. Like the ebullient guy. Now, does he hate you? Is that why you got so bad out of shape yesterday?
No, he's a chronic. He never had anything to say to
you. Well, that's
about
me. Fine. Listen, are we going to be picky? See, you should by now understand. Am I that stupid? I'm going to be picky now. We talked about 8 people already this morning.
Listen.
And 7 of them we could have lived without, but it's
sure.
It kills some good time, and we're getting paid for it. The hell's wrong with you?
He's a stalker.
Rimmer is the stalker.
Well, him too.
And he's here. At least the ebullient guy ain't here, but Rimmer is here.
Just
and I'm serious. I'm not answering my phone this weekend. If anybody I know calls me, don't worry that I died, although I might, but it's just that I'm not answering the phone. I don't want to be bugged by Rimmer. They're staying at the most expensive hotel in the city here, according to his voicemail last night. I'm getting choked up about it. I'm gagging on it. See, I just died. Okay, don't call me Rimmer. I died. So he can probably afford his own meals. No, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I know.
Damn it. Stalking me in Amsterdam, there they are. In Toronto. Over and over, I'm gagging on them. The stalkers. And you know what? My phone is ringing right now. My phone in the other room is ringing right now. That's the best. I love it.
Go pick it up.
It rang once. That was the best. Oh, God. I know who that was, too. Probably some pervert.
Hola.
Anyway, Mo Howard David at 34. Don't Fire Nobody 12. That was great. The Beast 9. George 7. Greg Reed 6. The Mad Dog's got 4 and Guilty 4. I can't believe this. What's going on with a surly crowd? No wonder nobody wants to be there. Pharrell's got 3. Orlando 3. I got 3. Most people only got a pair, but I got 3. One little one. Hank Goldberg 2. Joe Costello 1. And Mark Eisenberg, people are saying, who the hell is that?
Live and local. This is 560. The radio's all yours now. QAM.
You got a truck at every pump station around, and I know what they're charging is unreal, but they ain't rolling out the oil in the oil fields. Oh, can't you see me standing here? I got my back against the filling machine. This is the worst that I've seen. I used to pay $119. What the hell they jumped? Gas prices have jumped. Man, they have jumped. Gas prices have jumped.
Oh, yeah, thank you, Mr. President, for those low gas prices. For those record-high gas prices, $1.75 average. Unleaded crap. By the way, U.S. also lost 93,000 jobs in August. Did you see that?
Where'd they lose them?
On the non-farm. No, seriously, 93,000 non-farm jobs lost in August, just when they're peddling us a bunch of crap about, wow, the economy's turning around, everything's great, because they certainly can't talk about foreign affairs now, so now all of a sudden he's starting to talk about the economy, like he's, you know, putting all the pieces back together. Is he doing it?
No.
Of course not. If you could get one person fired at WQAM, who would it be? We're asking on Neil Rogers' talk. A little preliminary poll today. Beast is doing pretty well. Mo Howard David at 46. Don't fire nobody, 21. The Beast, 11. George, 9. But Greg Reed, 8. Neil, 6. Jim Mandich, 6. Hank Goldberg, 6. Geldy, 5. Orlando Alzequiri, 5. Pharrell's got 3. Joe Castello, 1. Mark, come on, somebody vote for Mark Eisenberg, please. You don't have any votes. And even though this is one where you don't want to have a lot of votes, if you don't have any votes, it's like you're being ignored. Nobody has any idea who you are.
Right.
Like you're not important enough for a vote. Now, this says Naples on 9, but we're always dubious. Here's Naples. Hello.
Warren.
Yeah.
Warren.
He's over in Naples, allegedly, but he's listening to a boring show. Thank you, asshole. Boy, you guys, he's a little bit too far south to get blown away with that tropical wave. Just wait. Mickey's going to be in the Atlantic. Here's Miami. Hello.
Morning, sir.
Yes, sir.
Have you seen Jerry Lewis's head?
Is this Woody?
Yes.
You know something? When I don't know what this is going to shock you, but when I pressed that button, mm-hmm. I thought it was Woody. I don't know. I'm not joking either. I knew it was him. I mean, would he call us on a day like this?
Yes.
He'd call us on a day. He would. It's Asshole Friday, and this goes to show you, only the losers stay in town. The other people, I mean, who have to stay there for their jobs, et cetera, well, that's another story. But the losers stay there at this time of the year. When it's 400 degrees in the shade and you've got all these tropical storms and hurricanes and tropical waves and all of this other crap and about 40 people doing the wave at a baseball game, which went out with knickers. Look at this. Caddo Valley, Arkansas, man charged with wearing a skimpy swimsuit. A man's skimpy swimsuit was too much or too little for Taco Bell workers in Arkansas. Employees at Taco Bell called police Sunday when the man walked into the restaurant wearing only a tiny black Speedo swimsuit and a cutoff T-shirt during the Labor Day weekend. Caddo Valley Police Chief Hiram Latin said his attire, or lack thereof, was a little too revealing. He was just hanging out there. He was inappropriately dressed for a restaurant, said Latin. He said the man had left his clothes at a lake. The man faces a $750 fine, possible jail time if convicted of indecent exposure. According to Arkansas law, a person can be charged with indecent exposure if he knows his conduct is likely to cause affront or alarm. Police ticketed the man and took photos of him in the Speedo for use in court. Can't wait to see those. He was just like hanging out at Taco Bell. Religion in the news. You got more of this, Roman Catholic. More of your anti-Catholic bashing again. Shame on that, George. I think you ought to be fired.
I know.
Three Sisters, Sue Los Angeles Archdiocese.
The story about that movie is kind of important because this is a monumental movie, and the church, of course, is doing everything in its power to keep anyone from seeing it.
You don't mean the Magdalene Sisters.
That's the one.
When Mary Norris went to see the Magdalene Sisters, a film dramatizing the inside the forced labor laundries that the Roman Catholic nuns once ran in Ireland, she saw her reflection and couldn't stop crying. What hit me the most was how they dehumanized us, said Norris, 70, who spent no relation to Gordon Norris, who spent 2 years in one of the Magdalene asylums that housed women deemed guilty of immoral acts. Her sin, she said, was sneaking away from her job twice a week to see a film. Until recent years, official silence and private shame have shrouded such grim experiences. But the Magdalene Sisters, directed by Peter Mullen, has won plaudits in Europe for shedding light on a dark chapter in Irish history. The film widens its U.S. release to about 50 cities this month. I did find the film depressing, but I'm so delighted that the subject is being aired so publicly because it was very nearly swept out of the carpet, said Francis Finnegan, a historian whose pioneering research on the Magdalene laundries inspired Mullen to make the film. An estimated 30,000 women toiled in 9 such penitentiaries in the early 19th century until 1996, when the last of the laundry shut down in Dublin. The last woman taken to the facilities entered 15 years before that. Oh, my God. It says the system began as a means of rehabilitating prostitutes, but quickly expanded to become a dumping ground for any woman deemed to have committed a sexual wrong, from giving birth out of wedlock to flirting. Wow. And it goes on. Well, we'll watch that film several times. Just like priests. See, the church likes to cover up all of this stuff because it's too embarrassing, especially on the heels of all their pedophile crap, which they're still kicking dirt on that, just like your dog out in the backyard to try to cover up his pile. Moe's got 49. Who should be fired at QAM out of 146? Don't fire nobody, 23. The Beast, 15. Greg Reed's got 11. Greg's moving ahead of George.
Oh!
George is squeezing his kneecaps. He's so excited about that. Well, because if there's any problems there, we know that Greg's got his... Oh, now George just moved ahead again. Mo 53, Don't Fire Nobody 23, Beast 15, George 12, Greg Reed 11, Mad Dog 8, Neil 7, Hank 6, Geldy 6, Orlando 5, The Big O, Pharrell's got 4, Mark Eisenberg's got a pair. Now don't get carried away, and Joe Costello's only got 1. Because nobody don't like Joe.
Nobody.
They just don't listen to his show, but they like Joe. Here's Miami on 7, hello.
I know who you guys ought to fire over there. The guy on Midnight, what's his name? Ed Kaplan or whatever?
You think that we ought to put Ed Kaplan on there?
That guy's terrible. He's terrible.
Yeah.
He's the most boring person I've ever heard in my life.
But he is a nice guy, but you're right, he is boring, and that gambling stuff is terminal. But he's a nice guy, though.
Oh, screw that. I mean, entertain me, for God's sake.
Okay, we'll put him on there to make you happy. See, nobody gets off on this one. I thought Eddie Kay was just such a nice guy, you know, everybody
benign.
Liked him. Huh? He is benign. He's kind of like a benign tumor in your radio. But let's put Ed Kaplan on there, Eric, because we don't, you know, why the hell should he get, like, special dispensation? He ain't even Catholic, for Christ's sake.
We're Sports Radio 560, QAM.
We're so sorry, Dennis Rodman. We don't stock and all the teddies in fuse and green. We're so sorry, Dennis Rodman. But the panties come with snappies to secure your little thing.
Bill Jackson notified me. He said you're very pretty, but you're dressing too petite. He asked if you would mind wearing something underneath, cause you're way too tall.
Way too tall.
Every time he jumps, you can see his basketball.
Man, you look retarded.
Retarded.
For a 7-foot-tall guy. Man, you look retarded. Retarded. For a 7-foot-tall guy.
There's a reason I played the Dennis Rodman bit, but let me take the lady in Coconut Creek first. Hello.
Hi, Neil. How you doing?
Pretty good. How are you?
Great. Welcome back. It was a long, hot summer here.
Long, hot summer for some. That's what I hear.
Yeah, for some. I wanted to tell George about the Rudy show tonight, but I guess he was too busy to answer the phone. But the Rudy.
I'm not answering phones, man.
He's not answering phones. He's
Scott
Jr.
I asked whoever's answering the phone to just tell George about the concert tonight.
No.
But I wanted to just say welcome back to you, because it's great to have you back. And when you deliver flowers to the walking dead all day long, it really cheers you up to listen to you, and I just wanted to say thank you.
Well, thanks, sweetheart. Have a great weekend.
Yeah, come to the poorhouse tonight and see Rudy.
Okay.
Live underpants song.
See ya.
You rock, Neil.
Bye. It'd be a long trip for me to make it there, don't you think?
I think.
Ex-NBA star Rodman arrested for drunkenness. Former NBA player Dennis Rodman was arrested today for yesterday for allegedly being drunk in public. Police in the L.A. area seaside community of Newport Beach said they received a complaint that a man on a boat dock had been drinking. When we got there, Mr. Rodman was at the dock next to the restaurant attempting to untie the boat, said police spokesman Jim Amorino. Deputies observed Mr. Rodman fall to the ground, Amorino said. They interviewed him and determined he was under the influence of alcohol, unable to care for himself or his property. The 42-year-old Rodman was taken to a Newport Beach jail before being released. He told ABC TV in L.A. he had not been drinking while driving the boat. I was just walking in my boat, he said. All right. See, what, you remember what I told you? A little piece of personal advice for everybody out there. Once a scumbag, always a scumbag.
Absolutely correct, sir.
Make no mistake about it. Now, Ferrall asked if I would plug this. I would plug anything for Scott because he's good people, okay? And because he's doing us a hell of a favor by doing the lead-in. And also because he gives us that separation from the Mo Man. Oh, brother.
Separation anxiety.
How this has changed my life and your life and everybody connected with his show's life. Believe me, because we got...
No more. No more.
Absolutely.
No more. No more.
Yeah, oh, what a machia, as they say in China. Ferrall will be at Ole Ole. Ole Ole.
Incredible.
On the Las Olas Riverfront, 6 to 8 tonight. He'll have some Finns tickets to give away. Probably a bunch of them because, you know, it's bogus, this sellout thing. It's just mind-boggling that we still got such a horse and buggy market that we have to, like, give tickets away and give freebies and have people buy up a bunch of tickets because we can't sell out the cockfights anymore, even in Sweetwater. Pretty embarrassing. Mario in Cooper City writes, I thought Ferrall loves the Beast. It sure sounds like it on the air. He even went to Pharrell's birthday bash on the cruise. Hey, he went to the birthday bash because it was free food and he thought he might get lucky. I think they're a good host-slash-producer combo. Neil and George, good combo. Mad Dog and his producer, good combo. It used to be that producer rarely spoke on here, but I think it's a well-adopted concept. Thank you, Mary Ann Cooper City, our new programming consultant. And
he's
major listener provocateur. Thanks, Mario. By the way, we love your restaurant, Mario the Baker.
See.
For your father, for your father. Well, that's Enzo, I'm sorry. Anyway, if you could get one person fired at WQM, you better vote on this fast, because once it gets to be about, I don't know, 11, how much past 11?
About 30, man.
Yeah, about 11:30, we'll put that second poll up, which I'll talk about after the top of the hour, or whenever I feel like it. 184 votes. Mo Howard David is leading the pack. He's off and running, baby. He's in a league of his own.
Absolutely.
He's got 64 votes. Don't fire nobody, 29. The Beast, though, 19. George, 17. Greg Reed, 12. Yours truly, I got 9. Mad Dog's got 8. I'm really surprised at that, aren't you?
I am. Totally.
He never gets any negative. It goes to show you how sour the people are there now. There's that big hurricane. What is it, Hurricane Julius or whatever it is in the Atlantic?
Orange Julius.
Near Bermuda. I say South Carolina's getting wiped out.
Excellent. Too bad for Hilton Head, though.
Neil, 9. Mad Dog, 8. Geldy's got 6. Hank Goldberg, 6. Orlando Alzaquari, 6. Ferrall's got 5. 3 for Mark Eisenberg, Joe Costello, 1. Eddie K. don't have any for that Schwarzer that I called before that said he was boring in his terminal in his car. Or that wasn't. It was Spo, not a Schwo. Remember?
Mm-hmm.
Giving me a song and dance. See, I did the right thing by not putting Eddie K. on there. He doesn't belong on there. Everybody likes him, even if they find his show boring. They don't want to see him get fired. Only mean, nasty, miserable people who are busy listening to Celia Cruz records want to get Eddie K. fired.
I am Celia Cruz and I am dead now, but I remember when I was alive. I will let it on the
Here's Miami. Hello.
This is Eddie.
Yo, wow. It's the retired guy now doing fake Eddie. Is this great or what? See, I'm looking forward to this today. You get too surly.
No, I don't.
Yeah, yes, you do. You get too surly. Maybe it's just me, but I'm just in the mood for this today. If everybody we talk to is a nutcase today, don't bother me none. I get paid just the same. Plus, we get tons of calls that way. You know what I'd be saying?
What?
I'm saying I'm here for the money. That's what I'm saying, which you already know. I don't give a crap about any of this garbage, okay?
I know.
It's fun. We be funning. Here's a call from Boca. Hello. Boca. Oh, my God. Boca passed away. I'll be goddamn.
Oi!
Missed up their chance to show their cheeks to the world. Here's a call from West Palm Beach. Hello.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Neil.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Zero on firing anybody. If I don't want to hear them, I just change the channel. I do my 2 segments every day and then move on.
That's quite a concept.
Yours being Ferrall and yours, obviously. On the lighter side, my wife and I, we've been here for about 7 months, and I got to appreciate your show because it's about the only thing that kept me sane here.
Right.
We're moving back to Central Texas. Which I'm ashamed to say is 60 miles too close to Shrubford, Texas there.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that...
So in other words, you lasted 7 months and you couldn't take it, right?
That's it, baby.
Well, good luck to you, Pally. See you on the Internet.
Okay, then.
All right, bye.
Bye-bye.
How do you like that? There's another one.
Yep.
They came from Central Texas with or without a banjo on her knee with the highest of hopes. And even not even the South Florida. Like, well, it is part of South. I mean, like Palm Beach County.
Right.
Couldn't handle it. They said, no way, Jose. They're putting their crap back in the old camper, and they're heading back.
That's a shot if you'd rather go back to Texas.
Right. Well, that's what he said. He's only 60 miles from shrub country, but they're still going back. They figure anything better than that. What are we going to do about it? Are we ever going to change anything?
No.
Is there any hope? Well, you know, that poll we're taking next.
Right.
I think that might be a start, you know, in addition to all of those busloads I talked about, the transfer of people, transferring the losers and the old dying people and bringing some living and breathing people who are in a good mood down. That might help. Here's a call that says Broward. Hello.
Hey, how you doing, Pally?
Pretty good, amigo.
Yeah, listen, you know what, you don't have it on the list, but how about all these sales holes you got working there that can't give you the right copy that, you know, some people do listen maybe to hear about some of the products that you do poach, you know, and... You know, you got old copy and you're knocking them, but some of those sales holes need to be fired now.
Todd Dreck. See, I mentioned that, and George said
even,
no.
Even
he said
Troy,
nobody.
Even Troy Stratford. But listen,
No, we don't want to fire Troy. Troy's a good guy. He is totally incompetent, but he's a good guy at least.
Is he the token there?
Yeah, he's the token schmo.
So listen,
I'll tell you one thing: he's a lot better than
Roy,
and has a much larger penis.
That's, I don't know about that. Listen,
and no oozing, bleeding hemorrhoids either.
Do you have a plasma TV, Neil?
Not yet.
Now, yeah, listen, I was in Philadelphia, and they got a new football stadium there called Lincoln Financial. It's a football only because they're going to implode Veterans Stadium after the baseball season's over, and they're going to get their own baseball. But listen, they got a 96-foot plasma TV. Hmm. It is so pristine. The place costs $560 million. They say it costs $12 to $15 million just for this plasma screen. Wow. Everybody's watching the screen and not the game, and they can't – the people say – that they can't take their eyes off the screen.
I'll be damned.
Take care, Pally.
You inspired me, though. I'm going to find out from the audience if getting a plasma TV is worth it. See, he's gone.
Yeah.
But now he was a good call.
I've seen him at Best Buy. They sure look sick.
You've seen this guy at Best Buy? How do you know him?
Not him.
Hiya, Pally.
Maybe that's a giveaway when he says
that. Hiya, Pally.
And it's not Fat Boy.
It was a giveaway.
Oh. I'd like to get a giveaway plasma TV. I hear they're really incredible.
They are.
Now, see, I don't have room here for a plasma TV because already my TV is too big for my room, for my living room, because the room ain't big enough.
You mount
this not far enough away.
You mount it on the wall.
It's mounted? I know some people have been mounted on the wall, like Clarence, or maybe just against the wall. Mo Howard David, I think, is going to win this baby. He's got 70 votes out of 204. Nice going, Mo. You are, like I said, in a leak of your own.
Absolutely.
Mo 70, don't fire nobody 34. George 21, the Beast 20. You passed the Beast. Uh-oh. Greg Reed, 13. Neil, 10. Neil Downs. Jim Mandich, 8. Hank Goldberg, 7. Orlando Alzagiri, 7. Geldy, 6. Ferrall, 5. Mark Eisenberg, 3. Joe Costello, 1. Eddie Kay's got 1.
Oh!
That little Spo voted for him. Eddie Kay's only got 1. See, what we should really be asking here, because they're not really voting on who should be fired. They're voting on who don't they like.
Right.
See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because if you're going to fire somebody, there's got to be a reason for it. And they can all vote for me. I don't really care. But there has to be some reason, like bad ratings, or you're not bringing in good enough revenue, or all of these things, you know?
Sure.
There has to be some reason for it. Like you're a failure, which probably why Moe's leading by so much.
Absolutely.
I would think so. But nevertheless, that's okay. It gives them a chance to spew some of their South Florida ventum, as the guy says. The ventum. Here's a call from Hollywood where they're loaded with it. Hello.
Yo.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
Pretty good.
You guys need to fire the Beast.
Yeah, any special reason?
I got a lottery. I can go on and on. He's
go
terrible.
Ahead. Take all the time you want, man. Take a couple of hours.
He's obese. He's fatter than fat itself. He reminds me of
the penguin. He's
obese? Yeah, I know him. He looks like the penguin from the Batman.
He does. Without the talent.
And plus, he's such a homer. The guy knows about Hurricanes football. That's it.
That's it. You're right. All he knows is Hurricanes this, Hurricanes that. That's it. Plus he sucks up to Zagacki so much it embarrasses me.
He's fat. He knows nothing about sports, and he reminds me of the Penguin. Therefore, he should be out of there.
Okay, thanks, Pally. Give him a big kiss for us. See ya. You have plenty of target. So the Beast, let's see, he's got 20, but you got 21.
Right.
That's just, you know what that is.
Yeah, I do.
The only difference being George is very thin-skinned and takes it personally, even though he'll deny it.
Why do you keep saying that?
Because it's true, because you still are, you take it personal.
Sure, whatever
you're uptight, you take all of these guys personal.
And I'm an illegal alien and a drug dealer and an anti-Semite and all these other things you say.
Right, but at least you're honest.
Mm-hmm.
But like the guy yesterday, that Ojean Provocateur...
The ebullient guy.
Ebullient guy.
He didn't say anything about me.
But you got so psychotic about it. See, and he don't even knock you, and you still were psychotic about him.
What does that have to do with being
a Finskin? But who the hell are you, like that bitch says, right. Who the hell are you to be deciding who I'm going to talk to or not?
I didn't decide.
See, that's what I call overstepping your bounds.
I said he had a bad idea. That's all I said. So you
that's
shouldn't
not
talk
all you
to him
said.
And didn't take a shot
you went,
at
you went on for many minutes.
About 30, man.
About he's a rambling and ranting and raving about that game. Guy, and why do you talk to him, and why do you listen to him, and he's that chronic, and he's a sick person, which, of course, you're right, but nevertheless. I mean, so what makes him that different from anybody else on who calls this show, most of them?
Nothing.
Well, there you go. He fits in like a rubber glove. Okay, the next pool. Now, we'll leave this to what, about 11:30, or is it you think it's finito?
No, whatever, 11:30 sounds good.
No, I think now.
Okay.
Well, no. What is there left to prove? I think that the places are. Although you are tied with the beast.
Well, refresh it one more time. 220
votes. That'll take a couple of minutes for Eric to change it. Last chance to vote on this poll. Who you're going to get fired on QAM? Mo Howard Davidson, star of stage, screen, and the Dolphin broadcasts, and Paradise. He's got 77 votes. Don't fire nobody. 35. The Beast 21 and George 21. Ever see the two of them together?
Yes.
Kind of easy to tell apart. Greg Reed 15. I got 10. Jim Mandich 8. Yoldi 7. The Humper 7. The Big O's got 7. Ferrell's got 6. Eisenberg 3. Kaplan 2. And Little Joe Costello, he's only got 1. Nobody don't like Joe. Although nobody wants another Joe. Am I right about that?
What kind of Joe?
Isn't that what Thomas Lucchese said in Godfather 3? Nobody wants another Joe. Joey Zaza.
Oh,
remember Joey
Joe.
Zaza? Joey Zaza.
I only saw that one time. That was enough.
Why do you say that?
Because that was enough. That was
well, I want to retract what I said yesterday. In spite of the flaws that we talked about, the movie was very... It had its tremendous moments, okay?
Great message.
Even Sophia. Even she was comically good. In other words, she was so bad that she was comically... Don't spend it all in one place when she gave the check for $100 million to the Catholic charities. Don't spend it all in one place. How about saving a little bit of it for a nose job, sweetheart?
Live and local. This is Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Friday, you bastard.
Welcome to Who Wants to Be California's Next Governor? I'm your host, Regis, and here are today's contestants. Superstar of the silver screen, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Superstar child actor, Gary Coleman. And finally, superstar of the porn industry, Larry Flynt. Welcome to you all. Now, let's play. Who wants to be California's next governor? Here's your first question. Hands on those buzzers, and good luck. Question number one. What is the capital of California? Arnold?
That would be Copenhagen.
Oh, sorry. Larry?
Not only is it the capital of California, but it's the porn capital of the world, Los Angeles!
Sorry. No. Gary?
How should I know, fool?
Well, you buzzed in.
What you talking about, Regis?
Well, let's move on to question two. Gentlemen, spell California. Gary?
What?
Well, you buzzed in again.
Huh? I just went to my probation officer yesterday, and I'm clean. I ain't buzzing on nothing.
Arnold?
T-E-R-M-I-N-A-T-O-R.
You just spelled Terminator.
Correct. And it's now playing at a theater near you.
Larry?
C-A-L.
Good.
I-F-O-R-N-I.
You're almost home.
C-A-T-E.
Well, Larry, you just spelled Californicate.
I'm elected governor. That's what we're changing the name to.
Well, all right, then. Question number three. Hands on the buzzers and good luck. According to the most recently adopted California tax code, what is the maximum amount of non-reported income that can be itemized on Addendum Form 17D without incurring a penalty? Arnold?
Reed, I would like to use my phone a friend and call my wife Maria.
I'm sorry, Arnold. You have no more phone a friends left.
Bummer. You see, she handles the checkbook.
Larry.
Taxes? Who pays taxes? If I'm elected, nobody's gonna have to pay a damn dime.
I see. Gary.
Now, Regis, I've been working as a security guard over at the Fresno Mall since 84, and this dude, Mike, well, he's kind of been paying me under the table, you know. But I promise if I'm elected governor, I'll make enough money to know what the hell you talking about.
Ha ha. Coma's getting paid under the table. Careful you don't bump your head down there.
Huh? Now, I know you just didn't make a joke about me being short.
What are you going to do about it, little man?
At least I don't sound like some Australian kangaroo.
I'm from Austria, you moronic midget.
You know, if I wasn't so damn busy proofreading the September issue of Hustler magazine, I'd get out of this wheelchair and shut you both up.
What you talking about, Larry Flint?
I would like to take both of you and twist you into strudel.
Well, all y'all got some
I will not take much more of this from
you both.
Oh, what do you know? It looks like we're out of time. Be sure to join us again for another exciting episode of Who Wants to Be the Governor of California? I'm Regis. We're out of here.
1104-560 WQM. Happy Friday to you. We got the Mad Dog at 2. The Humper at the Crystal Palace in the Bahamas. Another brutal assignment. And if you think it's tough doing a show from the Bahamas, 4 to 6:30, he's got the Dave Wonstad show on tape from 5 to 6. So the Humper's got a tough hour and a half assignment today. Marlins on deck 6:30, then the Marlins and the Expos in San Juan, Puerto Rico, 7:05. Eddie K follows the baseball game, ESPN Radio overnight. That's our schedule here on QAM. You're highly touted, highly rated, and we don't know why. Rick faxes me and says, stay away from plasma TVs. There's a fire hazard. The plasma heats up on the wall and creates this hazard. Sorry I bought one, says Rick. How do you like that? Not exactly what you call a real testimonial.
No.
You believe that? Well, I'm sure I believe it. If he says so, he knows his crap. He's had the,
why would he lie?
He's had the experience. Well, no, he wouldn't lie. Thanks, Rick. So I guess, although maybe if it heats up enough, it'll kill the rats in the walls. No, I'm a little bit concerned about that because the people at Crispy Critters came again down there the other day and they found three more dead rats in the attic. So that's a total of eight. Eight Crispy Critters in the traps.
Eight.
And they're coming today to, like, seal off all of the entry points and exit points and in and out and all of that stuff. But in the meantime, that's not a very appetizing thing. Of course, you're used to it. You got all kinds of rats.
In the shed.
Yeah.
Not in the attic, thank God.
Yeah. That you know about.
No, you'd hear them like you, like your experience there.
Like I said, if they're in the walls, you'd hear them rattling around, and you'd get really nervous and aggravated about that. And you'd start, you know, hallucinating all sorts of possibilities. And in the attic, not like you're doing. See, that's just, no. What the hell day was it? Last Sunday? Sunday night, Monday morning. I wake up at 6:30 in the morning. It sounded like there was a herd of elephants in my attic. No, they weren't doing that
either. I saw Willard.
Yeah.
Twice.
Where was he? In Michael Jackson's house? Singing Ben?
Eating
239 votes on the first poll. Finito. Okay, we're going to put the second one up there now. Should have something for you to sink your teeth into.
It's up there.
No, I know that. Will you? Well, I'd better vote.
I got one to add.
Okay, just calm down. We have no ball game today. We got a full 4 hours. And this is a toughie, too, because you only have one. Let me say that again very clearly, real queerly. You only have one choice. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? Four votes there just went up on a thing. We've only got five choices because it'll give you a chance to add to it, which I'm sure you'll be delighted to. OJ's got a pair, and Coulter's got one. Mo Howard David had one. Miss Drudge don't have any, and Jose Canseco don't have any yet. But they will. Now, getting back to that first pool, 239 votes. If you could get one person fired at WQM, who would it be? Oh, I forgot. I got to play Fired by the Mo Howard David Band.
Howard David Singers.
Yeah, the Mo Howard David and Singers. You know who I'm talking about.
Absolutely.
Mo Howard David wins this poll, hands down his pants to pick out Dingleberries. 84. 35% said, fire his smelly old ass. And the rest of them wouldn't be. I think maybe he could get himself a new career as a pizza delivery man. Because his show's been a big bomb. His show's been a big bomb. Don't fire nobody, 36. George, 25, edges out the Beast, who had 22. Aren't you a little embarrassed about that?
No.
No, actually not really, because you're the Beast is only on, like, doing updates and doing a lot of juvenile crap.
Name recognition thing.
Right. Greg Reed, 16. Neil, 10. That's a nice even number. Neil's a perfect 10. And the asshole list, I guess. Jim Mandich, 9. Orlando Alzagiri, the big, got a 9. Henry Goldberg's got 8 for the Humper. Geldy, 7. Pharrell's got 6. Mark Eisenberg, 4. Once they got started with him, they started getting a little carried away. Ed Kaplan's got two, and good old Joe Costello, I guess, is the most popular guy in a radio station, which is odd because he's on 2 to 5 in the morning, or maybe it's just that nobody knows who Joe is.
Who?
Joe Mama. Joe Costello only one, or most popular, although nobody wants to hear his show. They're just, if he was on like in the afternoon, or like in the morning when Mo is on, you'd be amazed at his number. I don't think so, though. He has that motorsports thing on Saturday mornings. Is that still on?
Let's check.
And look at that. Look at that. They moved Joe up to prime time now. He's 8 to 9 a.m. He used to be on like in the wee hours like Mo when they were trying to shovel him off. Hmm. And now we got the golf show with Mark Wood and Tim Rosdaforte, who I have no idea who they are. 7 to 8, and Motorsports Saturday with Joe Costello at 8, Joe Rose at the Mikasuckies at 9. How do you like that? And Joe promises me, because we got the big Dolphin home opener coming up on Sunday,
homo,
that his whole show tomorrow morning is going to be talking about
Howard from Boca,
which I can't wait for that. I might actually come in here and take a listen or two. That thing with a phone ringing before, that was sweet. That was just a beautiful thing. Okay, the early returns, if you could boot just one person. Well, we got to add, we get the list going. 17 votes. OJ's got 5. That's who I voted for. It was a tough choice. Because I'd like to get all 5 of these people out of that town. It would improve things dramatically. Ann Coulter, 4. Mo Howard David at 4. Miss Drudge has got a pair. And Jose Canseco's got one. Did they ever change the name of that street or not? I don't think they did yet.
I don't know.
They talked about it. Well, Scott would know. Scott Jr. there.
He was acquitted of that probation charge violation.
No, that wasn't what I asked, though. I know that. See, if you're going to tell me things like today is Friday, it's not really contributory in a very large way. But, you know, I know that.
My apologies.
No, don't apologize. Don't be a pussy, okay? You can do that on Mo's show, but don't be a pussy on his show. Stand up for your rights, and you'll be gone next week. But, no, seriously, they were still going to change it because they just decided he's such a scumbag. I mean, guilty or innocent, they don't care. They just are embarrassed to have a name in their midst. A street with his name on it. That would be like having Joe Gersten Way, you know.
Right. Well, in case you noticed, we don't have an embarrassment factor down here.
Or, yeah, like on Miami Beach, Arthur Godfrey Drive. I mean, I still can't figure that out. That's like Heinrich Himmler Avenue, you know?
Ain't that one block over?
What is wrong? It must be the old Hasidim, or it must be senile. That must be it.
The Hasidim.
One of the most virulent anti-Semites who ever set foot anywhere in the state of Florida, Arthur Godfrey, and on the beach where they got, or at least in those days, had nothing but Jews, old Jews, and they name a street after him. They probably get gas at the Hess gas station. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Yes, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, do you have a blood doll of Mo? Why do you keep talking about Mo, man? Retire. Man.
I have a suggestion for you, pal, okay? Oh, and now he's turning it up to hear himself on the air. Don't listen no Mo, okay? Then you don't have to get worried about this show with you and Mo. Yeah, Mo is big with the dark crowd. 567-0560-#560. See, that was in the last hour. Catch up with the times, okay, pal? First of all, don't be talking like that, and don't name your kids Anthony. Would be a good idea. Here's Palm City. Hello. Palm City. Long gone. How about Weston? Hello.
Hello.
Weston. Are we having another phone fart there or something? Weston, yes.
I am someone else that shares your wonderful plague of rats in the attic.
Yeah.
And I must say that all the companies that keep coming out there, the company I chose me about $500.
Right.
Dusted that place out, and those rats just do not want to leave. And I don't want to give any bad news, but you have to keep doing it. What happened was they came out over 4 months and dusted me about 8 times. And eventually, it was the air freshener that smelled like roses that they put in afterward that scared them all out of the attic.
The crow, maybe Warren Cromartie was hanging around there. They could smell that talcum.
I had companies coming out. They give you these flyers with these cartoon little rats, and they put these big bright eyes on you to scare the hell out of you. And eventually, once they seal it up, you're going to have to go back up there about a month later and just pick out the dead bodies.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Well, how the hell is that possible? If they seal it up, where the hell are they going to come in from?
They're not really all leaving. They want you to think that they're leaving, or they trapped them all, but there's so many. I had at 2:30 in the morning, I would hear packs of rats running into the house and running across my bedroom ceiling.
Pack of rats.
3 months.
Huh.
So it wasn't.
Yeah, I woke up a week ago Saturday when I was down there. I woke up in the middle of the morning, 3 a.m, I heard a voice going,
Eisner!
In my attic.
Did you hear the digging yet? The little scratchings?
Oh, yeah. That was last year I heard that, yeah.
You have to cut the trees. All the trees around the house is where they climb up, and then they go into the roof, and they use their claws and just get right into the attic. And people look at you like you're the most filthiest person when you mention you have rats in your attic.
Oh, yeah, you say that. Oh, my God, you must be some kind of a slob. You got rats in your house.
Yeah, and they look at you like three eyes or something. And then
well, you didn't use Crispy Critters. I mean, Broward, what do they call themselves, Critter Control?
No. Orkin wanted to come out, and they wanted to have like a whole six-month thing where they're going to come out every other day and charge you like $50 per time to bait traps and trap them and come back out and show you what they caught.
Right, that's what these people do. That's what Critter Control does. They come and they put peanut butter on the traps, and then every couple of days they come out, and then they tell you, oh, we got three today, five yesterday, and they charge you for each one they catch.
Well, my place dusted it with this dust that's supposed to make them thirsty, and it looked like a winter wonderland up in my attic. It coated everything up there. And
I'll be there. Well, at least it must have been really scenic at Christmas time, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, pal, well, good. You got rid of them finally?
Finally got rid of them. Once you seal them up, you're going to have to... I mean, I went up there just to check up there, and that's when I found the king of them all. All dead.
Right.
I called him Stuart Brittle.
Have a great lunch, pal.
Okay.
See ya. 11:14 at 560 sounds really promising, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's not a South Florida thing. There's rats all over the place. We used to have rats. When I lived in the Back Bay in Boston in the early 60s, I told you this, we used to have rats as big as cats in the alleys at night.
Sure.
And they would hang out in the garbage buckets, you know, and we would be walking home from wherever and kick the garbage pails just to, so they would, and they would howl like a wolf. Not like a cat, but like a wolf.
Yeah.
Just like that. 14 past 11 at 560 WQAM announcing a 2003 Neil Rogers End of Summer Clearance Sale going on this moment at Hallett Pontiac GMC. Get the lowest prices in town from our good buddies Tom Lehman and Joe Prieto and all the other good folks over there at Hallett. For this special promotion, every vehicle on the lot has been marked down to the absolute lowest rock bottom price. Plus, get yourself 0% financing for 60 months on every single 2003 Pontiac or GMC in stock. Buy a 2003 Pontiac Sunfire. You can get it for only $11,998 at Hallett right now, or get a full-size Sierra for as low as $15,998. But you better hurry your ass in there right now because inventories are mighty limited. At Hallett, you can still test drive any vehicle on the lot for 24 hours. Take it home. Take it to the racetrack. Take it to work. Take it to the massage parlor, wherever the hell you like. And, of course, Hallett's also got an unbeatable selection of dependable, certified pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs. Credit a problem for you, it's not a problem at Hallett, because some way, somehow, they'll work out a deal for you, even if George has to pay your payments. Hallett Pontiac GMC, 13401 South Dixie Highway. That's US 1 across from the falls, open every day, 7 days a week. If you want more info on these Neil deals, they got a special hotline you can call and ask away, 1-888-534-4211. That's 1-888-534-4211. Don't forget all Neil deals. Subject to credit approval. See the folks at Hallett for details. Hallett Pontiac GMC, when you go there the first time, you'll agree with me. They really are professional grade.
Live and local. We're Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Mackinac, this is Joe Bowen, the voice of the Toronto Maple Leafs, and you're listening to the Hockey Authority, Neil God.
Asshole, asshole.
Yes.
That Wayne Huizenga is such an asshole. He yelled at Mandich, that greedy turd, because he wouldn't take a shower with Engelberg. Asshole, asshole.
Hey, stupid.
H. Wayne Huizenga is such an asshole. He's just like Hitler and Eva Braun. What's that he's pounding on?
Excellent choice by one of our factions this morning. How could I have forgotten? Wayne Huizenga. We got him on there right away. Wayne Huizenga, get him on there.
Show enough.
Here's another one that says, please put Gay Fiedler. Must have been a typo, don't you think?
No.
No.
Gay.
Jay Fiedler on the poll. I know Mo will be upset, but Jay has got to go, says Diane from Fort Lauderdale Beach, and she is just Diane over there. Thanks, Diane. And we'll get back to you, Diane. So let's get him on there, Jay Fiedler. See, we'll build this list, even though the phone don't look too promising. See, this shows you that there's nobody around. Remember yesterday, gymnastics I had a good... Once we got going, we finally got a lot of suggestions. But that's generally because there's nobody there.
It was a nice ring routine you did, though.
What do you mean by that?
Gymnastics.
Yeah, but when I was, like, on the rings there, you noticed there was no package to check out. I forgot my kielbasa in Cologne. It was stuck in my cologne. Let's see. Oh, here's a good one. Big Arnie crying. This is a good choice. I don't know how we're going to spell this. Well, I think they'll know who it is.
Are you going to spell what?
Maris Greasy Ass.
I know how to spell it. I spelled it and faxed it.
Did you really?
Sure.
Oh,
spelled just like it sounds.
I wrote it down like Roger Maris. Maris Greasy Ass.
Mighty flaky.
Rest in peace. Poor Roger Maris, man. There was a guy. Was he a ball player or what? And good-looking guy, too. But he was in the shadow of Mickey Mantle, and the fans gave him a bunch of crap. And he played in New York, of course, with our obnoxious Roger Maris for president, even though he's dead. Be a big improvement over what we got now. Anyway, Arnie says it would be Maris Greasy Ass. I can't even spell her name. That's okay, Arnie. I can't either. It's the one in the alien thing, the one that had the illegal beauty parlor in her house that nobody talked about, and the one that married the 10-year-old guy. Thanks very much, Big Arnie. An excellent choice. See, we'll get this thing built. It'll be good. It's all good. Now, let me give those promos again. It'll kill some good time because we got all the way till 2 o'clock.
Oh,
today.
You can't do that yet.
Why? But why not?
Because I'm getting ready to fax you an update.
On what?
Van hits.
On what?
Van
on
hits.
On the what?
On the van hits. Miguel just handed me a new updated sheet.
Okay, just relax. Seriously, you need to calm down. I know you're under a lot of stress, and you went through that thing with that unwanted baby and everything, but, you know, you survived the Mo trying to get you fired business, but you've got to sooner or later. People are always saying that I'm hyper and I get too excited and hysterical about things.
I think you are.
I'm what?
You're hyper about me being hyper. I'm not being hyper.
I'm not the least bit hyper. Do I sound hyper?
I'm ready
to go into a coma just from the sound of your terminal voice.
Well,
no, seriously, you need to calm down a little bit.
I am calm. I don't know what you're talking about.
Scott, does he sound calm to you?
Yes.
Oh, man. Oh, so you got naked pictures of this guy, too, huh?
Who doesn't?
Wow. It worked. It worked on Beaner Boy.
No,
he, I guess he was helping Beaner with some supplies. 5670560 #560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. Oh God! Sometimes this job blows. Anyway, Ferrall, we don't have to change his promo, do we?
No,
good. Ferrall will be at Ole Ole on Los Olas Riverfront, 6 to 8 tonight, giving away Dolphin tickets and getting class student just having a gay, great old time. I'm sure 34C will be there. Maybe Scott Jr. is going to be there. Now, do you hang out with him, like, when he goes on these things?
No, I'm going home to the New York area.
You mean Jersey?
Yes.
Why are you so evasive? I mean, I'd be embarrassed to be from Jersey, too. I mean, I'm from Rochester, and that's nothing to crow about. But Jersey, I'd be embarrassed. But you don't have to be, you're among friends. And George.
If you say so.
Oh, man, this guy, I guess, don't like this job, does he? Okay, let me see.
Jose Canseco way.
What is it?
It's still there, Jose Canseco.
Thanks for the information, Scott. Now shut up.
Thank you.
Let's see, Best of Neil, 3 to 5 this afternoon. You can get the CD and the Mohawk David keychain and whatever else we got left over for Abandoned Pet Rescue. Miguel will be at the Coconut Creek Seminole Casino, 5550 Northwest 40th Street, just off Sample Road, west of the Turnpike. And, because Miguel is a hard-working man, in spite of the fact that he feels drained from his daily Doreen experience. Do you think his new bride knows about that? Join QAM tonight at the Hooters in Bayside, 7 to 9 p.m. Stop into and prize enjoy a bucket of five for $8.50. What does that mean? What does that mean? Are you reading this?
Nope.
No, obviously you didn't, and then you just faxed it to me. I want to read it the way it's written. Join QAM tonight at the Hooters in Bayside, 7 to 9 p.m. Stop by to win prizes and enjoy a bucket of five for $8.50 Presidente beer.
There you go.
What? Well, what does that mean?
Bucket of five.
For $8.50, President. What is that? It's a non sequitur. What does that mean?
Bucket of five.
So did he give you an update on the van, what we got or not?
No.
Oh, man. Just another useless spick. Here's a fax from Bill in Fort Lauderdale, who still hates George like football, but I notice he didn't put that in there this time. Oh, brother. Johnny Depp is a backpedaling pussy, right? Oh, God. You know what? Bill is an asshole. You know what? He said Johnny Depp is God, and he's got the balls, and he's a good guy. Got the balls to, you know, tell it like it is about Bush and about what's wrong with America. Those are the people who are the true patriots, the people who want to point out the problems and say, hey, we got to fix these things, as opposed to the blind, idiotic, flag-waving idiots, the lemmings, the sheep, the morons. But anyway, Bill says, plasma screens are only for those who have more money than they have sense. They have a very short shelf life, some as little as 3 or 4 years, after which they burn out, rendering the set completely useless. If you don't mind shelling 10 to 30 grand every few years to have that quality of picture, then go right ahead. Be my guest. As far as I'm concerned, the high-end HD sets are quite suitable for just about any broadcast and will last many years. Thanks, Bill in Fort Lauderdale. The guy I always said had good common sense. Well, so his, you know, he's a little off on Johnny Depp. Plus, even if Johnny wasn't talking politics, he still looks pretty good to me. 26 past 11 at 560 WQAM. VIPsportsbook.com is South Florida's best sportsbook. Anybody, anyone with a brain knows that. Now, you can listen to some of the little quizzlings we have on the air. They're all, hey, this is the best sportsbook, boy. They're really great. If you want to get yourself involved with a real outfit that knows what they're doing, that you can trust, this is the place you want to hook up with. 99% of those other bookies you hear about on this station are located in the jungles of Costa Rica. If you ever see them again, it might be a miracle. So this year, move yourself up in class to VIPsportsbook.com and prepare to plunge in peace. They're the oldest and the biggest sportsbook in the Netherlands, so that speaks for itself, 100% legal and licensed. So listen to me and call VIPsportsbook.com right now at 1-866-VIP-BETS because they're South Florida's best sportsbook. Sign up right now and you can bet all the South Florida football and basketball teams juice-free all year long. You want to bet on the Dolphins? It's 100 to win 100. You want to bet the Hurricanes, it's 100 to win 100, so forget about the vigorish. All signups get a 20% cash bonus, not some funny money match play bonus. And by the way, the people at VIPsportsbook.com emailed me yesterday and said, by the way, I want to remind you that Gary Sarner is a major asshole. VIPsportsbook.com, that's where you find him online, or call him toll-free, 1-866-VIP-BETS. That phone number again, it's 1-866-VIP-BETS. Be sure to mention you heard about it here on QAM. VIPsportsbook.com, where you be the VIP.
Live and local. This is Sports Radio 560. QAM.
Rolando el pollo para acá.
Gonzalez, why the hell don't you go home and stop all of that whining from all the crazy Julios? Go back to Cuba with your papa, where you can play in the mud. We'll pack your beans and enchiladas, just go away, we're all fed up. Hey, Leon Gonzalez, why don't you go home? Go home and leave us all alone.
Señor Lisi, I don't want to go back. I like shopping for free toys better.
You got your Pokemon t-shirt and your Mickey Mouse ears. You've had your fun, now start packing so they can get you out of here. It's at the point where we can't stand it. Everybody's had enough of all the Julios and crackers. Who puts a dunt in Florida? Hey, 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 the young Gonzalez, why don't you go home? Hey, the young Gonzalez, go home and leave us all alone.
Radio Lisi, look, they're giving away free SNH green cards. Can I have one?
Oh, there's the plane to take me back to Cuba. There's the plane.
Shut up, kid.
11:32 at 560. That was a really amazing. That was such a good micro spasm, you know, of what South Florida is all about and the way Dade County is held hostage by a bunch of old Julios. It's really astonishing. Just making crap up as they went along. Brainwashing. Remember that videotape that they had him make?
Oh, yeah. It wasn't staged, though.
No. Thank God for that. Maris Greasy Ass. She wasn't prompting or anything, was she?
No way.
No
cue cards. No cue
cards. Not that greasy ass. 119 votes on our second poll. This is the main poll of the day, the big poll. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? O.J. Simpson, 48. They hate you, O.J., and deservedly so. Who did you vote for?
Mo Howard David did.
Oh, just because he tried to get you fired and he's a major asshole and everybody hates him like poison?
Yes.
Good reasons. O.J. 48. Well, but at least he didn't kill anybody yet. Mo. O.J. 48 and Colder, 26. She kills me. Mo Howard David at 20. Jose Canseco, 12. Miss Drudge has 4. Alex Pinellas, 3. Oh, I don't even know we put him on there yet. Did we put him on there? Was that just a...
Oh, I wrote that on. I forgot. I was trying to say it, but then I forgot.
No, that's good. That was an oversight. That was a slip of the tongue. Maris Greasy has 2. Wayne Hypinga's got 1. And Jay Fiedler's got 1. Why do we want to kick Jay out? I mean, wouldn't it be enough just to kick him off the team? Wouldn't that do it?
Yeah.
Don't want to get Mo too upset. He really has the hots for Jay Fiedler. You know, but when you get to be in your 90s, your eyesight starts, fading a little bit. 5670560, Pound, let's add a whole bunch of names for this list here. This is the weekend poll here. Let's go. Let's get with it. Here's a lady in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes,
hi,
ma'am.
I have 2 suggestions, but I just have a feeling you only want one name.
One, please.
Oh, then I guess Reverend Kennedy.
Oh, man. Excellent choice, Reverend James Kennedy.
I need to change my vote.
Yeah, me too.
I think overall he does more damage than the other person I was thinking of.
Okay, well, thanks a lot, sweetheart. Have a great weekend.
Yeah, you too.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
The unctuous Reverend James Kennedy of the Coral Ridge Presbyterian Church, one of the virulent bigot hate mongers in South Florida. Piece of crap. A professional anti-Semite, a professional homophobe, a professional asshole, the Reverend James D. Kennedy, with his Coral Ridge ministry seen all around the world via satellite as he continues spewing a bunch of caca and making a lot of tax-free bucks. By the way, your organist is a fag, Reverend Kennedy. Everybody knows it. The guy that plays the organ, hey, that ain't the only organ he's swinging with, you idiot. 54 votes for O.J., Ann Coulter, 27, Mo Howard David at 22, Jose Canseco. I just gave these. Why are you doing that again, George? Here's a call.
Scott
from Miami. Hello.
Neil Rogers, hockey god.
Yes.
Could we please put Jeff Rimmer on this list?
It would help. Hey, but if you booted him out of South Florida, he might be here a lot more.
Well, but it would help the local economy, and my mute button could get a rest.
Okay, Jeff Rimmer, he's on there.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Pally. And by the way, Jonas Hoagland's a stiff. All you other Panther people, how many Panther people do you think we got this season?
About 30, man.
At the most. What they're doing, and Rick Dudley saying a couple of months ago, oh, we got money to spend, and we got to pick up some great free agents, and we're going to really get some good veterans on this thing. Right. Todd Gill and Jonas Hoagland. Todd used to be good about 100 years ago. Even George knows that. You know what Todd Gill had in common with Troy Stratford?
No.
They both wore 23.
23 what?
Guitars. Oh, man, you know what I'm gagging on?
I give up.
I'm gagging on a blackberry seed.
Mm.
Now, blackberries have seeds that are really tiny, thank goodness.
That's right.
Really teeny tiny ones.
They're good. I could go for some.
But boy, I like blackberries. I just picked one out of the fridge during last break, just a little blackberry, and popped it in my puss. And now I'm gagging on the seeds. Or maybe that's because the guy just mentioned Rimmer. It's one or the other. Don't call me Rimmer, okay? I'm busy. Whatever you're doing, whatever time you want to go to dinner, I'm busy. I can't do it. No eating. I'm fasting for a few days. Whatever day you're leaving, that's when I have my next meal. Here's Hallandale. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Neil, I don't know if you saw the pregame show last night before the football game.
I didn't watch no football game last night, sir. I didn't see that. I know Lardass was on there.
Well, the one on ABC where Britney Spears and Aerosmith were performing.
No.
Britney Spears was performing, right?
What was she performing? Oral sex on Al Michaels?
Yeah, he wishes.
Yeah.
Well, she's there, you know, dancing up on a stage and singing, and she has like choreographed dancers dancing all around her. And then at one point, the dancers came up. She was wearing these like tearaway pants, and they like ripped the pants off of her.
Yeah.
Right. So, and then she's wearing a heel short.
Right.
But the thing was, is that when they ripped the pants off.
Yeah.
They almost ripped her shorts off, and it almost saw like her camel toe. Y en ese momento me empecé a hacer la paja porque ese bollo con yo me lo quiero tomar.
Oh, my God. It's your people, man.
I'm sorry I missed that.
It's your crowd. You missed what?
Whatever it was he was yelling about.
Oh, you missed the performance.
The event.
You mean you weren't watching the pregame show? George must have tuned in late just in time for kickoff to watch the Jets lose, a girls' team. Well, who did they play last night, by the way? Scott, is Testaverde playing? Is that it because the other kid's injured?
Yes. Testaverde's playing. They played Washington.
I know they played Washington. They lost 16-13. What? Listen, here we go with that crap again. Was that Miguel I just heard?
No.
Oh. 21 till noon at 560 WQM. We got the Mad Dog. We got a big weekend. We got the Gators going to get whomped by the Hurricanes. I mean, that's a given. Just, I wonder what the spread is on that game. Anybody got any idea? It's in that place, they ought to have an idea.
I don't know.
I mean, it's no contest. The Gators suck. The Hurricanes have got like a professional team, even though they warm up against girls' teams. It went by at least three touchdowns, at least minimum. And then we got the big Dolphin game against the girls' team, the Houston Texans. Who's the quarterback for Houston that looks pretty good? What was that kid's name?
Huh?
Dan, huh?
Stewart.
Dan Stewart. How's Dan doing, by the way?
Oh, we're fine.
Mike, and local. This is Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Off those checkered pants.
What's that crap they play down the hall?
That's power!
Power 96.
What garbage. The kids today don't know what's good. Like that song, I'm happy I live in a split-level head. You remember that? How can you... Listen. I'm happy I live in a split-level head. I'm happy I live in a split-level head. You don't remember that?
No.
No?
Why am I surrounded by morons?
Come on, Howie.
Don't you call me Howie. I've had enough insubordination from you, pal!
Ow!
Calm down, will ya?
You shut up, fatso! Okay, that's it! You're all fired!
You fat, stupid boob! You listen to me? You're fired! Guilty that goes for you, too! You know who I am? I'm the king of paradise!
I came down here after losing my job to be a big fish in a little pond. When they kicked me off ESPN, they told me don't come back again. I had some problems with wise guys who advised I move to paradise. Florida. Fire!
That back deal ain't no Louis Nye. That guy was funny. You're all fired! And I hope that Jim Guzzler dies!
I hope he dies! But I hope you all die! I'm a big fish in a little pond, see? A big fish in a little pond!
Is anybody listening to me? I'm a big fish in a little pond! A big fish in a little pond! A big fish in a little pond! Yeah! Why doesn't anybody enjoy me?
16 till noon at 560 WQM. Of course we get to Rick Sanchez. You knew that was just a matter of time somebody faxed that in.
How could we forget?
I didn't forget. I just want to give everybody else a handy crap because he's probably going to pass them all like they're sitting still. And, of course, Miriam Oliphant. How could we forget Miriam? We're trying to.
Out of sight, out of mind.
Boy, you talk about forcing yourself into a situation. Everybody wants her out, and she continues forcing herself. No, you're not going to get rid of me. Not when I'm this dark.
Reminds me of somebody else.
Yeah.
Howard from Boca.
Absolutely.
David faxes. David must be already got an early start on the weekend, must be doing the heavy drugs, because he says, thanks for your continual pulls. Even though it's meaningless, it's nice to be able to push a button and, in theory, kick Alex's penis out of Miami. He says, you missed the opportunity to put Mo on this one, too. David? Looks to me like Mo is in third place at the moment with 26 votes. I could be just hallucinating and imagining that. Now... Quincy in Miami, who lives in Sunrise. He's in Miami. He's being held captive there, I'm sure, because he wouldn't be there voluntarily if he lives in Sunrise. Quincy says, just this one time, Mo will not win a poll. Well, guess what, Quincy? You are...
Absolutely correct, sir.
Says, I really think I have your winner right here. Marianne Elephant, or whatever her name is. P.S. Mo still blows. No Mo Elephant. Please go to California and see Arnold, it says. That's an idea. Let's chip in. I'll pay for the whole airfare and coach. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? And so far, OJ is winning hands down your pantaloonies, man. 70 votes. Nobody's even close. Here's a call in Miami. Hello.
Jeb Bush.
What?
I'm just groaning.
Why? Why do you take the... Will you stop?
Well,
that's
personally.
What I'm trying to tell you. Why do you do that?
Why do I groan?
As soon as I punched up line 9, I knew it was him. So what are you getting so bent out of shape
about?
I'm not
bent out of shape. I'm just groaning.
And I've decided I'm not asking Scott no more questions either.
Okay.
Well, no, he doesn't want to talk, which is fine. That's a breath of fresh air. That's pleasant. He doesn't want to be on the air. We have some people around here, like the Beast, who want to talk too much, who add nothing, who are like an impediment to the success of the program that they're interfering with at the moment. And we got other people who want to be like major celebrities, like the one you picked up off the floor that day, who wanted to be make the website into like all Beaner Boy all day long, you know.
Hola.
You're right. Here's Beaner Boy with Ferrall. Here he is on a cruise ship. Here he is puking his guts out. Here he is at the baseball game. Here he is with some slut, you know. But we got a guy now who wants to say nothing. I was going to say who has nothing to say, which is a possibility, but he wants to say nothing. And he seems like, you know, a guy.
Yeah, he just
right?
wants a job.
He just wants a paycheck, which we can all relate to that.
Anything
if
will
we
do.
Have, if we have something sports related that I'll have, we'll have to defer to him since you know nothing, you know.
Right.
But if we have anything else, we'll just leave him, let him sit there and stew. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. You'd think we'd have a lot more names than this. Just like yesterday, you'd have thought. And then they finally got into it. After about 20 or 30 mentions, they finally understand what it's all about. They're just a little flow. Here's Hollywood. Hello. Hollywood is gone. Nice talking to you, Hollywood. That's your town.
Mm-hmm.
Here's Key West. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Neil.
Yes.
Gloria and Emilio Estefan.
Oh, I like it. Let's pick
yeah.
Gloria because he's small potatoes.
If you can have a pool with them every week, they will win hands down.
Okay.
Bye.
Hasta que mil vidas. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon line. Monday, George is going to be on playing the Luis Miguel records all day. And that's just a joke. Well, if I say that, they'll take it serious.
I am Celia Cruz and I am dead
Celia?
Now, but I remember when I was alive. I will let it do the little I will do the well.
I can't believe we're not getting any more calls about the rats. Can you imagine how many people in this audience have had rat problems? I'd like to know if anybody else has ever used Crispy Critter Control. I mean, Critter Control. Because I'm
okay.
using them and spending a lot of money, and it
really?
Seems to me like, what?
I use somebody else and don't spend a lot of money.
Well, that's what I was going to do, but somebody in my house, I don't want to go picking on anybody, but somebody misunderstood my message, and they called Crispy Critter Control, as opposed to calling our good friends at ATM Alternative Termite Management, and the Steve and those people who are so good.
Right.
But I'm
going to
give these
problem.
People another short period of time, and if this problem doesn't come to a quick halt, then it'll be the old ATM. Well, you, but you're telling me that you got rats in your shed.
Had.
Oh, they got rid of them?
Sure.
And it was ATM that done it?
Yeah.
Well, I'll be damned. Because this Crispy Critter crowd, see, I don't know, but when somebody called me about them the first time,
mm-hmm.
it was like, remember back in April was the first time I heard a rat gnawing and scratching and we had these people come out and they found nothing?
Right.
But if they sound like they're like Broward Animal, you know what I mean? Like an official
right.
county agency, and they're not. They're just another business.
When they first started coming over to the house for other things, they asked us what our pest problems were, and we mentioned it almost in passing. Well, the rats sure like our shed. We just can't keep them out of there. We put traps. We put poison in there, and they took care of it. They said it's an ongoing maintenance thing.
I mean, these people came and asked me who my pests were. I mentioned Rimmer, and I still can't get rid of them. Christ.
I think there's a special...
I mean, what is that all about? I'm in Amsterdam. I'm thousands of miles away. Here come the Rimmers. I'm in Toronto. How many times has he been up here since the last 3 years I've been doing the shows here?
About 30, man.
Well, here, it's Rimmer. It's Rimmer. Go away, okay? Don't take it personal unless you want to, but just go away. Or I'm going to tell Ken Halpern about you. God. Here's Miami Beach. Hello.
Yeah, hi.
Yes, sir.
First, it would be the Schwartzes.
I beg your
what?
Pardon?
The
yes.
Schwartzes.
Schwartzes?
Yeah.
Arnold.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, yeah.
No, Schwarzenegger.
Get out of here, you idiot. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? He says the Schwartzes, which he can't, he don't even know what the hell he's saying. It's either Jews or dark folks he's talking about, or maybe dark folks named Schwartz.
Right, I bet Scott and Laura are really offended about it.
Yeah. Even Scott Jr. there ain't too happy about it, and he doesn't even know what the guy's talking about.
And he isn't even here.
What does that mean?
He had to go to New York. I'm sorry, Jersey, the New York area.
Oh, he's already gone, so that's why Miguel is there?
That's it. He's out of here.
I thought Miguel was just filling in while Scott was taking a big dump or something. I didn't know what the hell's going on. And here I'm talking about Miguel getting bone and Doreen every day, and he's sitting right there. Well, that's good. That's good. Maybe we'll get him off the hook for old time's sake. Fort Lauderdale, hello.
Yeah, how's it going, Neil?
Pretty good, Pally.
Yeah, the spread on the game there that you were looking for is 14.
14, oh, piece of cake.
Yeah, and I want to vote for that Dago faggot, Mad Dog.
Five, six, seven, I'm not even going to dignify that with a response, okay? I remember that show the day he said that. Pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. I'm playing music today. You know, I'm playing Celia Cruz. No, I really am. This is...
I am Celia Cruz and I am dead now.
It's just depressing play that over to and over. Me. I don't know. Like, this whole week. See, I expect too much. Too much. Come back after a wonderfully pleasant summer, not getting sick one day, not having the Amsterdam crud, any of that stuff, working only Tuesday and Thursday. Come back to the full-time deal. I'm down there for a week. I'm plagued with rats. And I come up here and the weather is beautiful and I'm happy as a pig in slop. And, you know, you open up the Hershey Highway via the airwaves to South Florida. It's like, you know, they're just heaping, their unhappiness at everybody. Don't heap it at us. Don't be our fault. It's not my responsibility. In fact, not only that, but look at it this way. If it wasn't for this show, can you imagine these people probably blowing their brains out already? Like the one guy said, the guy that's going back to Texas with a banjo on his ass, he said, and he's right, this was the only connection to reality and amusement he ever had while he was in South Florida. Here's a call from Boca. Hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Pretty good.
I had that rat problem myself.
Yeah.
I cut every tree around the house, away from the house.
Uh-huh.
Took care of the problem. Haven't seen a rat since.
So in other words, but they don't stay, what do? Like in the base of the trees they nest or something?
They nest all over the trees, they come through, and then they climb up onto your roof and things like that through the trees. So
I'll
I had a guy,
damn.
You can tell me if I cut the trees away from the house, they wouldn't come near the house anymore, and I haven't seen one since.
Excellent, I'm on it. Thanks, pal.
Well, I got one for your poll thing.
Go ahead.
How about Rick Shaw? This guy's 180 years old, he's got the same hat on he's had on for 30 years. That's enough of him.
Okay, thanks, Pally.
Sure. All right, buddy.
Poor Rick Shaw. I'm sure he's listening right now, isn't he?
Yeah, yeah.
We love you, Rick, but go away. That's what the guy's basically saying. You've been here too long. Oh, here's an answer for my rat problem on two. It's in Miramar. Hello.
Hey, Mr. Rogers. I got the
yes,
perfect
sir.
Solution. It'll take care of rats and any cockroaches that you may have.
Rats and roaches?
Yeah, the next time that you get ready to go back to Toronto when you're down here, go out and get 10 gallons of ammonia, regular
yeah.
household ammonia.
Uh-huh.
Set them up in each room of your house, open them up, and leave, and then go up to your Toronto. When you come back, you will not have a roach or rat problem or ant problem at all.
Just from the smell of the ammonia?
Just from the smell of the ammonia. The ammonia will seep up through there. They don't like the ammonia smell.
And then what happens when you take the things of pneumonia away?
They'll be gone because they'll have the memory of the fact that you know, the spell that was in there.
So, in other words, they kind of memorize the addresses of the people that got the ammonia?
Well, I wouldn't say they memorize it, but, you know, it's kind of like a Pavlov-type thing.
Right, it's like a deterrent, right.
Yeah, but it'll work 100% guaranteed.
Okay, thanks, pal.
You're welcome.
I don't think John would be too happy about that, but, yeah, it's too bad. 567-0560, 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. I'm depressed that you told me ATM did such a wonderful job, because I knew they would.
Right.
But he misunderstood my note that I left one day when I came to work, and he called Crispy Critters again.
Alas.
And maybe they'll be fine. I mean, they have caught 8 rats so far.
Right.
They put the traps up there with a peanut butter. And if you ever get hungry, you know, well, we've got like a little snack waiting.
Just get some crackers.
Right. But it just seems to me, I mean, there could be dozens of them if they're like living in the trees. I didn't realize that rats lived in trees. I thought they...
Everywhere, anywhere they want to live.
Really?
And they go anywhere they want to go. That's why they explain that it's an ongoing thing. All the pests in Florida, pest control is an ongoing maintenance thing that you have to stay on top of. There's no just treat and then forget about it. Your house is going to be clean forever.
No treat and eat?
No.
Well, I've got
to retreat.
Well, how come I've been in that house all of these years and up until April of this year, I never heard of one rat scratching. I never had nothing in the attic.
You've been lucky. It just took them a while to find you.
I'll be damned. Bastards. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon line. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? Here's Miami. Hello.
Jeb Bush.
Does Jeb Bush live in South Florida?
Just put him on there, asshole.
That's the guy again. Mm-hmm. That's him. Just put him on there, asshole. I didn't know the guy had a talking to himself problem. 567-0560, pound 560 on the, I'm gonna tell you, we got some real, real people in that town, don't we?
Yeah.
And this is the place to find them. If you're looking to meet and greet some real people, this is the show you'll find them on. Here's the poll so far, OJ 79, and we're not putting Jeb Bush on there, by the way. Luckily, he lives in Tallahassee. In a tree. Ann Coulter's got 42, 80 now for OJ, 42 for Ann Coulter, Mo Howard David at 35, Alex Pinella 16, Jose Canseco 15, Miriam Elephant 8, Wayne Hypinga 7, Miss Drudge has got 5, Maris Greasy has 3, Jay Fiedler 3, go away Jay, go back to Dartmouth, Rick Sanchez 3, Reverend James Kennedy 2, none for Rimmer or Gloria Estefan as yet.
Live and local, this is 560.
The radio's all yours now.
QAM.
This is Mark Morgan. It's the 12 to 1 hour on QAM.
Oh! Some of them are brown. And then some are gray.
And then some are gray.
I think you get the trees cut down. I think that's the answer to my rat problem, don't you? It might cost a few bucks, but who cares? Get them trees cut down. Not just trimmed, but get rid of them.
All right.
Remember I had all the Malaluca trees, and I was always, oh, brother, that was for years.
Mm-hmm.
For years. And I had all the allergies and the skin and the headaches and just, and it's from the goddamn Malalucas. Maybe that's why so many people down there act like assholes, but from the Malalucas. That could be it. It's a good excuse. Right?
Sure, let's play the tree lady.
I think the tree lady had something to do with it. Rest in pieces. Rest in branches. That this rat, we got the rat thing, we need a solution for that. We got the plasma TV, which we won't get a lot of calls on that because, you know, you have to be loaded to have a plasma TV.
Right.
How many people in South Florida probably ever had one?
About 30, man.
So what are we going to get on that? And we're asking if you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T. And Verizon Wireless Line. Here's Kendall. Hello.
Hey, what's up, Neil God?
Yes, sir.
Before anything, give me a vote for the rim job. One vote for the rim job.
Yeah.
And your rat control problems, this is what you need. All love.
Here's a call from Kendall. Hello.
Hello. Dwight Lauderdale.
Is this Dwight Lauderdale?
Yes.
Leave that alone, Dwight. People are starting to talk. I'm not putting Dwight Lauderdale on there. It's ridiculous, isn't it?
Right.
Just on the face of it, it's ludicrous. Just because he likes eating a little ass, I mean, no go getting all bent out of shape. It's good enough for George. It's good enough for Dwight people. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT. We're just moments away from a...
I am celiac losing, I am dead now.
Medley. And hey, don't kid yourself. I still got that disc. I got all kinds of good stuff, baby. Oh, yeah. I got La Negra Tiene Tumbao.
Yeah,
well,
that's the one. That's our favorite, right?
That is a major, major hit. I got La Traidora, La Vida es un Carnaval, La Jaibera, Oh, Muñecas del Cha-Cha-Cha.
All right, my favorite.
Cidias Oye Como Va, Yerbarito Moderno, Cuando Sali de Cuba, Ven Venabe. I got Aquarius, which Marilyn McCoo will probably blow up our transmitter if I play it. I got Juan Tantameda, Hueso y Pelejo, En La Punta, and I Mi Cuba. Oh, that's what's coming if you people don't get with it. I'm tired of playing like school marm to this town. It just makes me nauseous, you know?
Well, you look kind of like a school marm.
Yes, I do, as a matter of fact.
Kind of marmy.
Auntie Neil. 567-0560. I don't really give a crap, okay? I mean, there's no hope for what I look like, and I'm still doing just fine, thank you. I'm doing pretty damn well.
Yeah.
I think you might be shocked. 567-0560, pound 560, believe me, on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. That's why I don't have time for Rimmer, okay? I have too many social engagements. I don't have time for the Rim Man, and it's the whole sorry act that is that he keeps slapping around. It's Rimmer, like an announcement, you know, like, here I am again, go away.
It's Pat.
Don't go away, man, just go away. I don't need to see you this time, I just saw you at the doctor a week ago. Who the hell needs to see you again? You look the same. God. Just latching on, the whole, this thing with this Klingon business, I can't deal with that, you know? Being a Klingon all your life. Have a good time. I mean, his kid is here. His kid's engaged. He's going to get married. He's got a good job with a fan. The kid's doing great, you know, which his kid probably ain't too happy they're here either.
Hey, did you already get this story?
That someone
just faxed? Who's counting the dead in Iraq from Herald.com?
You just faxed it?
No, somebody just faxed it to us. I'll fax it to you.
We already had this one on our website that sent me about the FCC's attempt to implement rule changes permitting big media companies to dramatically extend their control of communications in the U.S. hit a major roadblock yesterday when the 3rd U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals halted implementation of the new rules.
Oh, that one.
I beg your pardon?
I said great.
Well, what's the other one?
I just pitched it. Who's counting the dead in Iraq? Remember the enemy counts and blah, 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 blah. You've probably already seen it.
What are you talking about?
The story that someone just faxed.
Yeah, and?
And I'm sure you already have it.
Bring back Scott Jr. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. 88 votes for OJ. They despise you. They want you out now before your next bunch of crap, okay? Before your next, before the next time the girl, the blonde goes nuts. What the hell's her name?
What's her name?
The blonde bimbo that's always with the drug stories and all that other crap. The one he's got down in South in Kendall.
How can I forget?
249 votes, and OJ's got a hell of a lot, 88. Ann Coulter, they're not too happy with that slut either, 43. Mo Howard David is tied with Ann Coulter. Ever see the two of them together?
No.
Same person. She's got
Prody.
A better piece. What?
Christy
Prody. Got it. 43 apiece for Ann and Mo. Alex Pinga Pequeña, 17. Jose Consucco, 15. Miriam and the Elephant, 12. Wayne's Hypinga, 7. Miss Matt Fudge got 5 with Rick Sanchez, who just went on the list and has already passed several others. Jay Fiedler, 4. Reverend James Kennedy, 4. Maris Greasy Ass, 3. Gloria Stefan, 1. None for Rimmer, okay? See, I don't know why I put him on there. It's like piling on, you know? Just piling on. All these wise guys out there, especially these Schwarzes calling today. Oh, God, give me the Rim Man. Give me the Rim Man. Then the guy starts going with his Arnold crap. You know, amateur comedians. Ted Mack is coming back to life. He's going to be conducting amateur hour at the Broward Mall this weekend. Go over and have a good time. Get out of our face. All these wannabe sit-down comedians. Here's a call from Kendall, home of OJ. Hello.
Uncle Neil.
Yes, sir.
About rats in your attic.
We had
a family of coons in our attic. And they left droppings, and it was terrible and dirty, and they tried all this stuff. And it turned out one time they said, leave a radio on up there.
Like this show will do it. It'll drive them away.
I'm not kidding. And we tried it. It didn't really help the situation, but you got to watch out. Once they had a possum, and it fell down into the wall, and it died down in there.
Oh,
in
no.
In my little brother's room, they had to tear the wall open. It stunk. That pesky critter guy came out. He vomited, smelling that stuff.
He really?
Yeah, it was this bad. You got to get it taken care of, because if they die up in there, oh, the smell is awful.
Oh, I know that. They told us that, which is why on a holiday weekend they just put the traps up there with the peanut butter, and they didn't set the traps because they said if we get anything and we're not back for 4 days, the smell's going to be so bad it'll make the house like a stench house.
Yeah, but if they fall down into some crack where they can't get the body and it rots in your wall, you have to tear apart the sheetrock, and it's an awful experience.
Mm-mm-mm.
Yeah, but listen, I'm
So you used a Crispy Critter Control?
We used, I think, Pesky Critters down here in Dade. It was this many years ago. I don't know.
Yeah.
I think it was Pesky Critters is the name of it. And then they have another one as an animal removal guy. There's actually a whole bunch of professional people, if you can believe it, here in South Florida who do this work.
Oh, I know that. We're using them, and they're charging me an arm and four legs. But we'll see. Okay, thanks, pal. Good luck to you. He had some coons in his attic.
Yeah.
Well, he put the radio on up there, and of course they didn't tell him he shouldn't have put on 99 jams. That's not a good idea. Brings more of them in. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. Should have put Rush on there. That would drive anybody out.
I like Rush. That was the first concert I went to.
Canadian boys, eh? They were at the Stones thing here a few weeks,
yes,
a couple weeks ago, whenever the hell it was. They were at the Stones, AC/DC. Let me say it again. That was one of the proud moments in Toronto in the history of the human race. 500,000 people, no events of any significance other than throwing some water bottles at Justin Tinkerbell. And everybody's gone.
All right.
Yeah. Even Britney was like low-fiving it. Deep throat and Madonna. You know, if she's going to stick her tongue down some bitch's throat, not Madonna, you know. Oh, please. Please, sweetheart, don't contaminate that thing. Speaking of Dennis's rod man. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hello.
Miami.
Sell Miami?
Yeah. Sounds like it to me, yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Don't be sorry.
Couple things. You want to buy a plasma?
No, I'm just inquiring. I don't really know if I want one or not. I'm trying to find out.
Oh, I can talk to you because I can talk to you if you want off the air about it because I sell them.
I see.
Call them. Good. Best quality. High def. You can use your computer at the same. Put your computer into it. You can put any kind of video device into it.
Well, the facts I got from the guy before said that they overheat, and again, they're a fire hazard, and they're right against the wall, and they burn out in 2 or 3 years, and you wasted a $10,000 or $15,000 investment.
Nah, we use them in rental for trade shows. We use them all over the place, man, and we've gotten lots of years out of them. So.
Okay, well, thanks a lot for your objective analyzation. The guy's peddling him, and he's calling me to try to sell me one, see?
What a concept.
Yeah, well, you know he's going to be very objective, right? Because he's not going to tell me any of the bad stuff. Sorry, pal, I'd rather go out and buy a cheap car for that amount of money, have like a fifth car to have around. Well, just why he needs another car payment sounds good to me. It's 11 past the hour. We got O.J. in first place, and quoted, she's never going to catch him. Because he may have the arthritic knees, he may be getting really old, but that O.J. can sure still run.
We're Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Friday, you bastards.
OJ, 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 you killed Nicole.
That night, when she turned off all the lights, there's no place where she could hide. Oh no, OJ was gonna get her. OJ went out to kill 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 her. That night. One day, the jury's gonna set free OJ. For all we know, he's gonna head your way. Oh yeah, and OJ's gonna get ya.
Is gonna come after you, and then he'll get away with
1217 at 560 WQAM. Here's a good suggestion for this poll. I love it. It says, how about posting that tax evading, lying, cheating bastard, Mickey Arison?
All right.
It says, take his, make him take his boats and basketball team with him. Maybe he can join his old man in Israel. You know the old man?
No, I don't.
Rumor has it that he sleeps with the gefilte fishes. Yeah. Yeah, don't you remember the $9 billion that he slept over to Israel to avoid paying taxes on him in this country? There you go. So, yeah, slip him to Mickey. Get Mickey Arison on there right away, please. Thank you. OJ's got 96. I mean, that's a given. He's got, like, a little more than double. Ann Coulter, she's got 47. Mo Howard David has given Ann a run for her money, 44. Alex Pinga Picania, 22. Jose Canseco, 15. And Miriam Elephant, 14. Everybody else is small potatoes in single digits. If you could boot one person out of town, out of South Florida, who'd it be? Here's a Lighthouse Point. Hello. Like I said, here's a call from Lighthouse Point.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I just want to let you know, Lighthouse Point has a big rat problem, but cutting the trees down, that's one thing you got to do. But the rest of it, you got to get somebody to go around the house with a can of, you know, that spray foam. Every little opening you've got. Do you have air conditioners in the roof, in the ceiling?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they got those vents that go up the side that they run the drain lines through.
Yeah.
They just run up those like it's a ramp. And until you seal off the house to where there's nowhere they can get in with the foam, they just keep coming back and back. I mean, I had them eat through my fascia to get inside the house.
You had to eat through your face?
Yeah, they ate my face.
Oh,
but they ate right through the fascia, and so it was a three-year
deal.
The fascia? Yeah, the fascia board.
I don't have any idea what
that
is. Uh-huh.
Right where the gutter is?
Right.
Well, they dug up behind the gutter in through a little tiny spot of rotted wood in the fascia.
Oh,
they were
my
going,
God.
Yeah, they were going in through that. Then you close that up, and then you find they're going up the those little square boxes that are on the outside of your stucco that run the air conditioning pipes up and down.
Uh-huh.
They got the foam around that. It's like a rubber stuff that insulates it. Well, they just dig their claws in there and run up and down it like it's a highway.
I think it's time to kill the bastards, you know what?
Man, let me tell you, I had 3 years. I'm so glad now I don't, well, knock on wood. I'm not going to say it, but it's been a good couple of years. But they just...
Yeah, don't give yourself a canary, man.
Yeah, but until you get the outside sealed off, and I just went around with the can of foam you buy at Home Depot.
Right.
Just, everywhere it looks like they can get in the house or in the
everywhere is a little crack, right.
Yeah, and then when we remodeled the house, we took the vents, the soffit vents, and because they would climb in and out of that, we put the razor wire in there that you use for stucco,
mm-hmm.
so that they can't climb in and out of that anymore. And like I say, for 2 years now, it's been
excellent. Sure. Okay, thanks a lot, pal.
Hey, good luck with it.
I'll need it. Thanks.
Oh, and by the way, Dwight Lauderdale, gotta go.
Okay, well, we'll put him on there. That's the second person suggestion. I don't know why. Poor Dwight, just because he's a silly goose. Dwight Lauderdale. Hey, all you rats, it's time to face your maker. Time to face your music. Sounds pretty complicated to me, you know?
It's not really.
It's not? Because it's, I could be wrong, but it seems like when they put the trap in the attic with the peanut butter, it's like a magnet. And all they're doing is they're like attracting them to come in and from the outside, and they don't hang out there. It's not like they've set up camp or anything, but they come in and they eat the peanut butter, and of course if some of them get trapped, fine, and if not, they're right back out the same way they came in, and that could go on forever. You see what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Am I right?
Yes, you are.
So what are we accomplishing besides making crispy critters a lot of money? Or whatever the hell her name is. 5670560. By the way, I'm not buying no plasma TV. I'm sorry that I read that fax before. The guy had good intentions. I'm not getting me no plasma TV, all right? Maybe I could use a little plasma, but no plasma TV. George says he could use a little plasma for his asthma. Here's Miami. Hello.
How you doing, Neil?
Pretty good?
My thing for the poll, Belkiston Ray.
Is Spilkiston Ray?
Yeah. I don't know who decided to promote her to, like, head anchor. That was a very interesting
She's thing. The head anchor?
Yeah, on the news now, down here.
Are you serious?
Yeah, Lori Gittens.
Smokey's Nerea is the head anchor on Channel 7 News?
Yep.
Which is an oxymoron?
Well, not with her if you know all the stories.
Okay, we'll put her on her.
Neil.
Yeah, I do know some of the stories, yes.
Neil, and on the Jeb Bush thing, technically he is a resident down here. He's just living in Tallahassee because he's governor.
Yeah, but he doesn't, forget about him. Okay, have a great weekend. Goodbye. I already said no twice to Jeb Bush. We're not putting him on there. He doesn't live in South Florida. Don't give him any encouragement, okay? Maybe he's got a house, whatever the hell he's got. Pup tent, apartment. Stilkey's the Ray and Dwight Lauderdale. We're starting to get some of the TV people on there now. I mean, you know, if we want to do that, we can put Angela Ray. I don't know. See, they don't understand the significance, the deepness of these questions of mine. Follow what I'm saying?
Ever? Yeah.
It's always, well, who do you hate? Who don't you like? Well, you know, enough of that negative stuff. We're talking about something really positive. No, it's positive for South Florida. It's like getting rid of the rats. It's the same concept. It's a one-topic thing today. Rats and human rats with two legs. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? I hope he hasn't put Rick Shaw on there. Did he? No, don't put Rick Shaw on there. That's bad. It's just going out of your way to be an asshole to do that. Tell the Rick Shaw I would do to these people. Ann Coulter. Well, I'm not going to read down the list. We got 291 votes. I'll just give you what we got. OJ 100. Nice even 100 for OJ.
Oh!
Let's hear it for good old Jay. Ann Coulter 47. Mo Howard David at 45. He and Ann seem to have quite a battle going on. Neck to neck, ass to ass. Speaking of ass, Alex Pinga Pequena 23. Miriam Olafant 17. Jose Consucco 15. Wayne Hypinga, 10. Oh, now that Scott Jr.'s gone off to Jersey, we can talk about him behind his back, right?
All right.
Well, no, I talked about him while he was there.
Sure.
I don't know about him. The verdict is out. I don't. Where the hell did you find this stuff?
I didn't. Don't go hanging him on me.
See, I try to be. I mean, Scott Ferrall is great. We're delighted to have him. He's going to be a gigantic hit, have big numbers. He's a great lead, and I'm glad to promote his things, which I will in a second. But, you know, I mean, he doesn't add anything to the program. You follow what I'm saying?
Right.
Did I say program? I'm sorry, Mo. Never do it again.
Absolutely.
To the show. Does he?
Yeah, he runs the board.
No, that's not adding something to the program. You could have a goddamn trained monkey. We could get Precious from Passions to run the board.
He'll talk all you
in
want.
In addition to which, he ain't doing a hell of a good job on that either.
Well, he never
come
did
on
that
yesterday,
before.
The phones aren't, can't hear the phones.
He never did that before.
So what does that mean? How long has he been doing it now?
A week.
Well, that's plenty. I mean, is this rocket science we're talking about? I mean, if even a putz like Robert Grieper can do it, how hard can it be? Right?
Medium hard.
Well, I don't think Robert Grieper has ever been medium hard. Maybe like a little, like a tad.
Pole.
Maybe he's got a tadpole. That could be it. Because he sure don't have anything human between his legs. So I don't know about Scott. I guess we'll give him another week and then we'll can his ass while we do a search. No, see, this is your fault. You're the one I blame. You're the one I went out and find that rat head.
Yeah.
Speaking of rats.
I didn't go out and found him.
Then
found
we what? What do you mean you went out and found him?
I said I didn't go out and found him.
Beanerhead?
I didn't find him. He found us. He bugged me for 2 years.
What did Miguel just say?
That's my boy. Miguel likes to rub it in.
Yeah, no, you found him. In fact, you were saying that you were feeling bad because you were responsible for
right.
it.
I am bad. I am feeling bad. I let him talk me into getting him a job here.
Oh. And then you allowed Scott Ferrall, who, as much as we like him a lot,
We needed somebody to run a board. They had absolutely nobody. He volunteered.
Now he's got a job. And
no, he doesn't.
What do you mean by that?
What do you mean by he has a job?
We're talking about running the board on this show.
He's not getting paid yet.
He's not getting paid?
Or maybe not ever.
So, in other words, this is all a scam. This
they
is a
promised
clearance.
Him, they said this and that. They told him a whole bunch of things, and you know how that goes.
So, in other words, he's just hanging out there like they were sucking Miguel into doing there all those months.
Right,
he's getting
exactly.
Paid the only difference being that Miguel is on salary, and he's paid to be in the building, and it's a hell of a lot better than getting pinned up against the wall by Doreen with a giant strap on she's got. So, you know, but at least in this case, in other words, he's not even... See, you don't tell me anything. I feel like I've lost control of this show, you know?
No.
I didn't tell you anything.
What are you talking about? I would have told you if they'd hired him. They haven't hired him, so I didn't tell you that.
So in other words, he's just kind of hanging out there because he's a buddy of Scott Ferrall.
You're as up to date as ever. Like the last conversation that I had about with him, that all still applies.
What does that mean?
That when he came in here to be an intern, to train, to run the board, that's still what's going on.
So he's an intern. He's still learning.
Yeah.
On our dime. On our time and on our dime on this highly rated show. No wonder we got problems, man. I'm thinking maybe the Beast.
Live and local. This is Sports Radio 560 QAM.
It's Friday, you bastards.
I'm a hillbilly Republican, but f***er. Inbred, retarded, and comfortably dumb. I'm a big dick and Bush supporter. In Saudi America, the country I love. God bless America, it says on my truck. Watch the guzzer tattooed on my nuts. Run the ocean shiny, don't care about me. I wear it on my sleeve.
Squat down on my pulsating stack. And let me watch your balls slapping on my lap. Come on, good Christian brother, help me get off. As I gaze upon my naked dick's a John ass drop.
Younger than dog do, just like Georgie's brain. That's why I'm devoted to him. Democrats are commies, dissenters and gays. Christ-killing Jews living in sin.
Boy.
I'm a hillbilly Republican, but f***er. Inbred, retarded, comfortably dumb. And I believe any goddamn thing they say.
All right.
12:32 at 560 WQM. We used to be the Neil Rogers Show, and now I feel like I've lost control here. I feel like I've been like a big, fat, old stepchild.
Oh, it's like Tom Jicka said, you know, you're in Toronto, you're out of touch.
I'm out of touch, yeah. That must be it. I'm not touching it. Something really rotten in South Florida. I can smell it all the way up here. Must be that ammonia the guy was talking about. That Imodium D. Because I haven't got any idea what's going on there. All these stories about this Scott is this, and Scott's a friend of Scott Ferrall, and
yeah,
and the phone lines are flashing, and now Miguel is sitting there, and he told me this morning he was going off to Jersey, but he never said when. Then all of a sudden he just disappears. Oh, well, he's gone. He caught a plane to go home.
Right.
What?
And I told you as soon as it happened.
Bull crap. I'm sitting here talking to him. I'm sitting here talking to him, thinking that he's there, and then you say, oh, he's gone. I mean, I know I have these great psychic powers, but I'm not exactly Reva from Guiding Light, you know.
Miguel came on the mic.
Well, he could have been, he's done that before. Scott could have gone out to take a crap. Haven't you ever gone out to take a crap? How many times you go out to take a crap during the show today?
About 30, man.
So there you go. You think you're the only one that's full of crap? Miguel's got some crap in there. Believe me, that's what Doreen said. She said he's full of crap, and that's only because she's pissed because he won't do her. And neither would anything else alive. Even the rats in my attic wouldn't touch that bitch. But anyway, see, you're trying to sidetrack me again, knocking Doreen. The fact of the matter is, we don't have to, you know, have like a big simus, especially on a Friday going into a nice weekend. A big simus about this.
We are?
Yeah, we are. I like I said, we need to have a big simus about this.
Okay.
I'd like to have like somebody in there who like is communicative, you know, who might like once in a while, which leaves Miguel out.
Well, it's because I told him to shut up.
What?
I told Scott
to shut
up. No,
it's not because you told him to shut up. It's because he has nothing to say. He has absolutely nothing to say. I say we get the Beast in there. What do you say? Huh? Let's make a swap. That's a good idea. How come I'm hearing like silence? How come I'm hearing silence?
I don't know.
You don't think the Beast would be good for that job?
I'm not recommending anyone for anything. I'm recommending movies is all I'm doing from now on.
Yeah.
I'm not recommending anyone for
just
any
like
reason.
Ed Wood, which turned out to be a bitter disappointment.
Oh, sorry.
5670560. Let's do screenless the rest of the day because Miguel's obviously under a lot of pressure and he can't be bothered with that.
Thanks.
No, seriously, I don't want you to have to go through that. In addition to which, you know, you already stressed out from Doreen. If anything of that creation were chasing me around, well, I already have the stalker up here. I got Rimmer. That's a good poll question. Which is worse, to be chased by Rimmer or Doreen?
Mm.
Yeah. Aventura, hello.
Why are you so miserable?
There he is. Why are you so miserable? The Whisperer with the same old crap, but he's still there every goddamn day with his one or two lines. Retire! Why are you so miserable? You're pathetic. You're tragic. Why don't you go in a rat? We'll see if we can catch you in a big trap, okay? Let's stick you in a goddamn bowl of ammonia, you jackass. You piece of turd. Man, I flushed better things down this morning.
You turd.
Than you, asshole. And have a nice weekend. Ferrall will be at Ole Ole on the Los Olas Riverfront, 6 to 8 tonight, giving away Dolphin tickets. Whoopee-doo. I mean, go see him. And Miguel rhymes with Ferrall. In Coconut Creek at the Seminole Casino, 5550 Northwest 40th Street, 3 to 5 this afternoon, just off Sample Road, west of the Turnpike. And then, if that wasn't good enough, join QAM tonight. Now, who's going to be on that? Are you going to be on that, too?
Yes, sir.
Wow, Miguel's busy beaver today.
You have no idea.
He said he likes busy beaver. Join QAM tonight at the Hooters in Bayside, 7 to 9 p.m. Stop by to win prizes. Enjoy a bucket of five. Now, you're there, now what does that mean?
A bucket of five President of Beer for $8.50.
Well, somebody teach this boy Inglés, okay?
Hey,
a bucket of five for $8.50 Presidente beer. You're starting to speak like Lucy, okay? Like Desi Arnaz.
Lucy,
you know. Enjoy a bucket of five for $8.50 Presidente beer? How about a bucket of five Presidente beers for $8.50? How does that sound?
Yeah,
huh?
That sounds much better, I know.
I mean, I like to sound like a cultured guy, even though I'm a fat old slob. I like to sound like at least I'm not illiterate, you know? I like to put on a good act for these people. So whatever, go and see Miguel and tell him he's...
And get some beer.
Get a bunch of beer, okay, and buy some stuff. Buy some of our Best of Neil stuff, because if we aren't over 20 grand by next week, oh, we got to be over it right now, but we're not getting any more reports more.
I forgot the total on my desk. You're at 19-something.
No, we were at 19.4 before yesterday, even. We had 19,400 before the show yesterday.
Right, you're still in that vicinity.
Well, what the hell does that mean?
What was it? Since the other day, you have $240-something dollars online.
Well, that's not going to cut the mustard. What is with these people out there? We got our Best of Neil. We didn't even put a CD out last year. We got the 2002-2003 CDs. We got the Mo Howard David keychains. We got some of those Mad Dog. We got all kinds of good stuff for Abandoned Pet Rescue, which is a sensational charity, by the way. And you can read all about it right there on our website. Just click onto the thing there. Boy, yeah, you're right. This is not the time of the year to be doing anything. But whatever we get now, it'll be gravy. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because we can go like we always do, right through January 1. But it'll just be a little icing on the cake, a little gravy, a little mashed potatoes, whatever. But, boy, this is... I guess I shouldn't be bellyaching the fact that nobody went to the Marlins game yesterday, because no matter if they win every game, which they have been lately just about, there's nobody there to go. There's nobody there. Just like, look at this, I'm doing Screamless right now. There's one call ringing on the thing. I say we just do that best of, that comedy bits are 4 hours a day till the people come back.
All right.
Don't you think that's a good idea?
Absolutely.
Like about a week before my vacation in December sounds good.
Stop dancing, George.
WQAM.
You.
Yes, sir.
What's up, man? I got a clown for your poll.
Okay.
How about Danny, I Can't Win a Super Bowl in Reno?
Why is that? Is he playing on the team now?
No, but he lives down here in Weston.
And so was he bothering you?
He kind of looks funny, no?
Yeah, he does have bad lips, you're right. Now get out of here. Get out of here. What's you people are mean, you're cruel, you're nasty, you're rotten. Danny can't win a Super Bowl Marino. Next to Pavel Bure, the greatest athlete who ever put on a jock strap for a South Florida team. No question about it. And maybe even superior than Pavlov and his stupid brother. And here this guy, see, this is the problem in South Florida. You didn't know, you could never do enough for them. It's always, wah, wah. It's always the old crybaby act. You're a bunch of crybabies, man. You make me sick. I'm so glad I'm not there. I can't begin to tell you. The only negative thing I can find in Toronto right now is the Rimmers. That's the only thing. And you know what the good news is?
What?
They'll be gone soon.
Live and local. We're Sports Radio 560 QAM.
In Miami.
You never know when the power might go.
Oh no, damn it, I was almost there!
This is the worst power outage in American history.
And we're out of batteries! What do I do?
Introducing the Hummer H3 Solar Powered Vibrator. Need more power? Then you should get the Hummer H4 nuclear-powered kickstart remote-controlled vibrator. Hummer alternative energy vibrators. They won't leave you hanging.
Call 44 at 560. Speaking of the Hummer, we got the Mad Dog at 2. The Hummer will be on 4 to 6:30 from the Crystal Palace in the Bahamas, including the on-tape Dave Wants That Show 5 to 6, and then the Marlins game from San Juan, Puerto Rico. Marlins on the Expos. Big series, man. Humongous. Eddie K after the baseball game, ESPN radio overnight, it's bad. music business to give file sharers amnesty. Oh, before I do that story, which I found on Lynn Samuel's website. Nice going, Lynn. The thing with this Krispy Critters, I'm starting to realize how stupid I am, you know? Because okay. You know what they do is they set the traps, they put this peanut butter crap that they have like in a tube.
Okay.
They stick the peanut butter, what a concoction on the traps. And then when they come back, they go check the traps. So if there's three rats, they charge you so much per rat that they catch. Well, okay. I mean, that's like catching fish in a barrel, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
I can keep setting those up there forever, and the scent of the more of that peanut butter I slop on there, the more they're going to get the scent, and the more they're going to come marching in wherever the crevices are, and of course then they keep stalling off when they're going to come and close everything up there because they're really busy, we're really busy, you know, that crap.
Mm-hmm.
And in the meantime, I'm paying them to catch fish in a barrel. What the hell's that deal? In addition to which, probably most of them animals wouldn't be going in there if they weren't smelling the peanut butter in the first place. It's not like they're up there running around all the time. They're not there. They're, like you said, out in the trees. They're hanging in the hood. Right?
Rats.
Rats in the hood. Boy, oh boy, what a schmuck I am. Krispy Critters my ass. Well, this is their last chance this weekend to get that whole house like hermetically sealed. And if I find one possum, one rat, one coon anywhere near my house, then the Schmidt's going to hit the fan. Then you'll see some real Krispy Critters in that place. Anyway, don't you agree?
Yeah, well, I agreed way earlier.
If you just set up a trap and put some crap in it, there's like 80 zillion of them in the hood, they're gonna smell it, you know.
And come running.
They're going to smell of it. Speaking of something that really stinks, the RIAA, the Recording Industry Association of America, plans to announce an amnesty program this week that will let individual online copyright infringers off the hook for old time's sake if they change their ways, sources say. Oh. The amnesty program would apply only to alleged infringers who have not been sued by the music industry trade group or identified by internet service providers as a result of the trade group's subpoena process. Alleged commercial pirates will not receive amnesty. According to the sources, the RIAA will not pursue legal action. I don't like the RIAA as much as I like that stuff I was talking about yesterday. That P.
Why? Oh. Why?
I love that. Too bad we wasted such a good bunch of shows this week on what we got down there now, you know what? After hearing from nothing but the misfits, pretty much.
Yeah.
Who never leave there. Anyway. They will not pursue legal action if infringers delete all unauthorized music files from their computers, destroying all copies, including CDRs, CD-ROMs. Huh. Why does it say CDRs? Isn't it CD-ROMs?
CDRs are the recordable CDs. That's
oh, that's right. That's right. Okay. And promise not to upload such material in the future. Each infringing household member will have to send a completed notarized amnesty from the RIAA. With a copy of a photo ID. Those who renege on their promise will be subject to changes of willful copyright infringement. The amnesty program will be revealed at about the same time. The RIAA is expected to announce the filing of several hundred infringement suits. The RIAA had no comment. Sounds to me like a trap, and they're not even putting no peanut butter on it.
Does it, in that story or any of the other ones that you've said, do they talk about which ISPs are actually giving up their users?
No. Well, wasn't it Verizon? Was that one of them?
I don't know.
Yes, it was Verizon. I don't know about the other ones, and I don't want to mention no names.
Right.
But at any rate, well, George is pretty nervous because, you know.
Huh.
5670560, pound 560 on the... I'm still porked off about this Scott thing, which I hate to do this on the air, but it's
well,
just...
What do you, I don't understand what you're porked off about.
I'm porked off at the fact that we got like some guy that got tossed in there because he's a buddy of Scott. And, I mean, he seems like a decent guy, but he's got nothing to say. He has no...
I told him to shut up. That's
no connection
that's
with the show whatsoever. And, you know, I think we bring Beaner Boy back. It's either Beaner Boy or the B. Somebody with a B. At least Beaner Boy was fun at a party. What are you laughing about? Yeah. It's the truth. I mean, I can't imagine too many bits that Boca Bryan's going to be doing about Scott Jr., can you?
Not yet.
No, well, I don't know. I mean, it's not that I'm picking on him behind his back, although I am picking on him behind his back, but I was picking on him when I was there, and he told
him to dummy up. Why don't you?
Why?
Because,
why?
Nobody wants to hear from him, that's why.
There you go.
See, Miguel has a pair, unlike George, who's again trying to be defensive, because at least you're two for two now. You're batting 1,000.
Well, people barely want to hear from George. Why would they want to hear from the board op?
Well, I mean, but if I ask him something, just like when I asked him what team he was a fan of, and we went through all these,
that's his way of being cute.
And being cute?
Yeah, that's what he thought he was.
He's about as cute as Doreen's ass, man. How do you like that? That ain't my idea of cute. Anyway, we'll work it out, okay? Or not, or just have the room empty in there. Maybe we can get the spots to run on autopilot. That sound good?
All right.
Okay, 5, 6, 7. We're looking today, and it's really a brutal, brutal Friday. I can't believe that this crowd is doing this to me today, but hey, I'm used to it. All these years.
About 30, man.
Never changes. Man, I'm as happy as a pig in slop. We're working on catching them rats with all kinds of peanut butter. Extra crunchy, by the way, this weekend with our crispy critters people. No, that to me, that's a scam. And I have to be a real moron, I admit. But when you're going to charge people for catching stuff that you're drawing in yourself, you know, be like, here, I'm going to give you, put a whole bunch of fish in a bowl, in a barrel, and give you a pole.
Yeah.
With
sure.
some bait. Yeah. And then every time you get a fish out of them, I'm going to charge you for it. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? OJ, you're in a league of your own, you and some of the others. OJ, 117. Ann Coulter, 53. Mo Howard David at 52. He's right on Ann's ass. I'd pay to see that. Alex Pinga Pequena, not doing as well as I thought he would. 26. Out of sight, out of mind. Miriam Elephant, 20. Jose Canseco, 17. Wayne Huizenga, 14. Ricky Ticky Sanchez, 13. Now, I know we added him on late, but I thought that we'd give him the handicap. He'd go zooming up there, didn't you?
I thought so.
Not doing well. 13. Reverend David Kennedy, or James, whatever the hell his name is, James Kennedy, 9. Miss Matt Fudge, 7. Maris Greasy Ass, 6. Jay Fiedler, 5. Gloria Stefan has got 4. Bell Spilkey's Nerey's got 1. Mickey Harrison, 1. None for Rimmer or Dwight Lauderdale. See, I told you don't put them on there. Didn't I say that? Well, I mean, I did say eventually put them on there, but I told you they'd get no votes. What is Rimmer? And if you kick him out of there, he's going to be chasing me all over the place like he's doing now.
Man.
Oh, I know. That was a big opening right there.
Wrecked him.
WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, my friend?
Okay, I'm doing great.
All the ISPs are giving up their members. The only one that had the nads to fight was Verizon.
I'll be damned. Oh, they fought at Verizon? I thought they were the first one to give them up.
No. They were fighting them in court. And, of course, with this Nazi regime we have in power,
yes.
They lost the battle.
I'll be damned.
So they have to give up all the names. Oh, well. I'll be up in Toronto, my friend. I'll be in Vancouver.
Yeah? Well, maybe I can hook you up even by Rimmer some dinner.
Hey, Surrey, British Columbia. Sounds good to me, my friend.
Have a good time, amigo.
Later.
Okay, light up a fat one for us. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T. We're doing Screamless now, and it still don't help. WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
I got another guy for your poll.
Okay.
Chris Bush.
See what I mean? Nothing but misfits in town. That's all we got. Every chronic, every regular, every malcontent, every misfit, every suckhole, that's what we got. And like I said, see, it's not me. After all of these years, I used to get a lot of the, oh, Neil's so negative and Neil's always knocking stuff. I'm just telling you exactly the way it is, okay? That's not the way I want it. That's not the way I like it. It's taken years off all of our lives that we've had to put up with such a bunch of miserable assholes, okay? That we've had to live in the midst of such a bunch of swill. God. Front-running, phony, baloney. I mean, any adjective you can come up that's negatory, I'll vote for it. Sad, it's pathetic, it's tragic, it's debilitating. Do I really give a crap?
No.
No, but it sounds good. It's good theater, like Mr. Ego would say. It's good drama. WQAM.
Yeah, I got one. How about Drew Rosenhaus? I'm so tired of him and his antics. Every show, every jock he's got signed up. And now he's doing Jackie Johnson.
I like it. Thanks, Pally. Oh, I don't like he's doing Jackie Johnson. I don't really care. She's a monkey face. She is. She's a monkey face. I don't care what any of you guys say. She is not attractive. She may have nice hair, but you know who else had nice hair?
I am celiac losing. I am dead now.
And she also was a monkey face, by the way. Now I hear she's kind of Schmidt-faced. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. In fact, the former chancellor of West Germany, remember Helmut Schmidt? They said he was Schmidt-faced. WQAM.
Yeah.
But he sure wore an interesting helmet. Yes, sir.
Yeah, that rat trap with the peanut butter is definitely a scam.
Yeah. Crispy Critters. It's called Critter Control, and I'm starting to get out of control thinking about what they're doing to me, ripping me off.
Well, actually, I use the rats for food for my turtles.
Yeah.
I have a turtle pen in the back, and it's on the other side of the fence.
is a storm drain. So I put the peanut butter out. They come over the fence. They eat the peanut butter. Get caught in a trap. I feed them to the turtles. So
excellent. Me, good idea. Good thinking. I'm going to go out and give me a turtle. When I was a kid, I had a turtle. It was called Myrtle the Turtle. And my whole life, I've always agonized over this. I think I threw it in a wastebasket before it was really dead. You know, I think it was just kind of, huh? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It was just kind of resting. You know how they pull their head in? Well, of course, you know how they pull their head inside.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know how that works. And then every now and then, we're like, pop right out when you least expect it.
Especially if it's a snapping turtle.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, sometimes they bite. But at any rate, it was called Myrtle the Turtle, and it was, Myrtle the Turtle, I don't know, it's so long ago, you know, it's about 100 years ago. I also had like one of them painted turtles, you know, those, that can't be good.
It's not. That must have been a long time ago.
Oh yeah, when I was like 5 years old, so that's like 56 years ago. I'm almost 61 years old. I'm so goddamn old, I can't even count it anymore.
No, that seeps into their, system and
kills
them.
Well, that's not good.
No.
So no wonder it got sick and I had to throw it in the wastebasket, in the garbage, in the garbage can outside.
They used to dye bunnies.
The name of the street we lived on in Rochester, by the way, was
Okay
Terrace. Ever can you imagine living? It was called Okay Terrace.
Was it Okay
Terrace?
And was it?
Now it's all dark, man. Really a dark neighborhood. Wow. Anyway, we're just singing along. We're just killing some time for you. We appreciate the fact that you're like hanging with us because it's desperate. It's just desperate down there. I'm so pleased that I'm not there. You have no idea. I was there for a week. It seemed like it was a century. I'm not exaggerating. You could see that I was at my wit's end. And then I get sucked into this crispy critter deal, you know, with these, we're going to catch 100 rats for you, and it's only like $20 a piece.
Well, I'm sending you a very encouraging fact that you'll enjoy reading during the break.
What do you mean by that?
That you'll enjoy reading during the break.
About the rats?
Yeah.
What a scam. Oh, we're putting a whole bunch. In fact, we got a gourmet menu we're putting up there. We're putting a rat buffet. You remember the
yeah. Smorgasbord.
Yeah. You remember the Negro buffet in that Phil bit? Well, we got a rat buffet, yeah. Although, if we put a Negro buffet up there, we might catch some possums. 12:57 at 560 WQM. By now, you've heard me talk mucho about laminates or us and how laminated wood flooring from laminates or us is the easy, low-maintenance alternative to natural wood flooring. Laminates R Us is the best place to find laminated wood flooring from the top names in the business, Peridor, Pergo, Wilson Art, Uniflor, and Quickstep. They've got all the top names all installed by Pergo certified installers. Here's another reason why you ought to be calling Laminates R Us. Their prices will positively floor you. Right now you can get their September kickoff special for just $1,995. That's correct. Just $1,995 gets you up to 380 square feet of beautiful laminate wood flooring. It is positively unreal. And Laminates R Us will match any legitimate written offer, too. So if you'd like to get you a free in-home estimate with no obligation at all, no pressure, call Laminates R Us toll-free, 1-877-777-3336. What could be easier? Free carpet disposal, free furniture moving, a 25-year warranty, and years and a lifetime of beautiful, easy care laminate wood flooring. Call them today. Tell them that old Crusty told you to call Laminates R Us, 1-877-777-3336.
And local. This is Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Okay, this is Scott Ferrell. And when I'm up in Boca Chica slapping old women with painted lips around the pool,
I listen to the Neil Rogers 1 to 2 hour.
I listen to the Neil Rogers Fair and Balance 1 to 2 hour.
Are you suffering from clinical depression? Life just not what it used to be. Spending your evenings with your mouth wide open watching reality shows. Too much of a sport hole to think about getting laid. Is that what's got you down, Bunky? Well, get a new lease on life at the Dr. Mo Howard David Depression Clinic. Dr. Mo Howard David is bored, yet certifiable, and is here to make your pathetic life worth living again.
All right, Sad Sack, what you be?
I'm depressed, Doc.
Yeah, I know that, you moron.
No!
That's why you're here, ain't it? Why, I'll have you know I cured many famous patients.
Yeah? Like who?
Well, Ray Combs, Karen Carpenter. Hey, I'm a doctor, not a chef. Now give me $50 and get the fuck out of here.
Hey, I came here to...
What, do you think I'm a fucking people poison? Scram!
Visit the Dr. Mo Howard David Depression Clinic today and receive a complimentary single-edged razor blade.
Dr. Mo Howard David, doi, wants you to die.
Oh, man. He must have gotten the good stuff in the mail, I'll tell you that. It must have come in from the islands. 102 at 560 WQAM. Tornado warning for the city of Miami, Florida. Did you see that?
No.
Hour. So there is now a tornado warning for Miami-Dade County until 1:30 Eastern Time. Apparently, we're going to see a continuation of this type of activity from Henri. One of the things you do worry about when a tropical cyclone makes landfall is the potential for tornadoes. I'm sure a tornado watch will probably be issued for Florida before it's all over. Certainly going to watch that, as that could be very dangerous.
Like I said, I sure miss being down there, man. That's part of that tropical storm Henri. And then, of course, you got the hurricane, the big one out there in Bermuda. That's going to wipe out South Carolina. But anyway, tornado warning for Dade County till 1:30. For a while, of course, this is on CNN. She's saying for Miami. I mean, what is that? That's the ass end of that big storm that's going to wipe out Tampa, Orlando, and Daytona Beach. So here's this fact. And did I just hear Joe Rose say the Netherlands?
I don't know. I don't listen to our spots.
Is that kind of like, is that like anywhere near the hinterlands? I'm sure that's, I'm sure that's what he said. The Netherlands. Joe, it's time to
grab the wood.
Yeah. Nice facts, though, that you sent me from my close personal friend Steve at ATM. Oh, why didn't John listen to me? I put the card out there, but I guess he misunderstood, and he called Crispy Critters instead about a week and a half ago when this whole thing started, and too late now. So what do I do? Because should I read this?
Oh, that's up to you. Just it's a for your information kind of thing.
Yeah, but I mean, how do I extricate myself from the first Crispy Critters people who are raping me by the dead rat?
I don't know what kind of a contract you signed, but if you didn't...
I didn't sign anything.
Then bye-bye-bye.
Yeah. But I mean, today's the day they're like sealing everything up. That wouldn't be the appropriate day to say bye-bye-bye, would it?
I guess not.
No.
In the future, though. Or as soon as they're done sealing it up.
Well, I'm going to save this, and then like we'll let you know the progress next week, and then we'll But it doesn't sound too promising to me, because it sounds, you know that old term, bait and switch?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm being bait and switched myself on that peanut butter crab. It's insanity. It's like saying, hey, look, I can catch all these fish out here. How much are you going to pay me for each one I catch?
Let me throw some chum in the water first, though.
Well, at least the fish, you can take them out on the grill and fry them up, you know, and have supper. Unless you want to eat dead rat and get maybe SARS or something, that's probably not a real good
idea. Why not? You wouldn't be the first.
5670560 #560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. We got so many problems and so many assholes. WQAM. QAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, my wife has a little rat problem at her place of employment there.
Yeah.
And they use Slim Jims in the trap.
Well, that sounds even more delectable than peanut butter.
Yummy.
Uh-huh.
I think they used about 70 traps up there.
And?
I think today was the day to go up there and get them all, I guess.
Okay, well, give me a report next week. See, he doesn't understand that if they're, like, putting in a Slim Jims, there's probably rats going to be coming in from Palm Beach County.
Right.
Right?
I'd go for
that. This guy works. I mean, that's just common sense. I'm really a lot dumber than I thought, but at least I admit it. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Lovely show you got going on. I got somebody for your poll.
Yes.
Joey the Terrorist Basulto.
Joey Basulto?
You. Yeah, Joey.
Who the hell's Joey Basulto?
I don't know.
Well, then we're not putting him on the poll. I mean, the name sounds familiar. One of those.
Sure,
those
one of those rabble rousers.
Huh? Rescue. Who is it?
Basulto's from Brothers to the Rescue.
Is it Joey?
Jose.
No, his name is Jose. Don't put him on there. We don't know who that is. Most of our people speak English. Miguel will vote on it. WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Neil.
Yes, picking.
Good afternoon. How you doing?
I'm doing sensational, man.
Hey, let me ask you a question. Why are all of these politicians getting in the middle of our sports? What the hell do they know? Why is George Bush coming on before the beginning of the season? Why is Rush Limbaugh doing commentating? You know, who the hell cares about, you know, what the hell the politicians have to say when we're sitting there trying to have fun?
So they can continue brainwashing the naive and unsuspecting public.
And how stupid we are?
Right.
And how
That's
naive?
Right.
And
right, we got Arnold running for the governor of the largest state, and you're asking me if the American public is stupid?
No, we already know they are.
Yeah.
Look who our president is.
Exactly.
Look who our governor is of Florida.
Right, right.
You know, it goes hand in hand.
Okay, good luck to you, sir. I'll see you at the border. I'll see you at the board. I'll give you a special dispensation to come across. 5670560, pound 560. I don't know what it is, man. Tuesday, I'll say it again. I probably shouldn't. It's called giving yourself the canary again, shooting yourself in the foot. I got up out of this chair at 2 o'clock on Tuesday and thought, man, we just right. kicked some serious ass. You know what?
You forget because you took almost no calls.
And, man, now as the week has gone on, week is the operative term, spell it with an A, W-E-A-K. Your neurotic station. That would be a good call it, isn't it? W-E-A-K?
Hope it's not taken.
Don't expect too much because this is weak radio. Oh, perfect for cheap channel.
Oh!
Yeah, nice going, Pete Bolger, you jackass. God, I wish you would die. WQAM, hello.
And the right wing is drilling it over and over into our brains that Iraq has.
See what I mean? They're all crumbling from the pressure, folks. They can't handle it. They're losing it. By the way, watch out for the tornadoes. Till about 1:30. We'll let you know when it's 1:30, and then you can run outside. WQAM.
You're so sad.
No, you're so sad, Carly. You're so sad. WQAM.
Hey,
yes.
How you doing, sir?
Okay.
Well, 2 calls ago, he let me...
Can't hear you, sir. Speak up. I can barely hear you. You're like muddy.
I was saying the caller 2 callers ago, he was leading into what I was going to talk about, the guy for the poll that I think should go out. Actually, it's just about everybody that ends with that last name, Jeb, Columba, the whole Bush clan.
Yeah, right. That really is an answer to my question. By the way, Jose Basulto is the guy's name from Assholes to the Rescue. That's the guy. Mm-hmm. We're not putting him on there.
Small potatoes.
Yeah, he's really small potatoes. Nobody knows who the hell that is. And this last guy is another one of those circle jerk guys.
Right.
5670560, he's probably got his nose up Chris Bush's ass right now. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. WQAM, hello.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
George is a lifeless loser.
And?
And he's a fat, greasy pig.
Yeah. And you suck, so there you go. Nobody's perfect. WQAM, hello. WQAM, screenless.
How's it going, Neil?
Okay.
You know why they use peanut butter, did they tell you?
No. I wasn't there. This was my roommate did all of this. I didn't see that.
No, they use the peanut butter because it sticks to the trap. Like, the rats get smart, and they'll knock the trap off, and then they'll just carry the food away. The peanut butter actually sticks to the trap.
Yeah. But I'm sure that the aroma of it attracts the rats, doesn't it?
I don't know about that. Anything will attract a rat.
Right. So what's the point? Let's say they know there's like 1,000 rats in the neighborhood and the trees and everything. They can keep putting food up there, and it's like, free buffet.
Yeah. Did they replace all the soffit screens around your house?
They're just supposedly doing that today, and they damn well better be.
Yeah, that's the first thing you got to do before you set the traps, or they'll just keep crawling in. Once they seal it all up, you should be good to go once they set the trap.
Well, we'll know in a couple of days. Thanks for the good news, pal.
Have a good weekend.
And you too. We'll know in a couple of days if Crispy Critters is really doing it, or if they're just giving out a rat buffet. Yeah, why don't we just, put a nice spread up there for crying out loud?
Sure, and maybe blow a whistle or something, I don't know.
Yeah, have like they do for the flamingos at Hialeah, blow the whistle and they all know, oh, it's time for brunch.
Or those dinner triangles that they ring?
Oh, yeah, like out on a ranch,
right.
Like in Bonanza.
Home
maybe Lauren
ranch.
Green can give it a little ding-a-ling. 12 minutes past the 1 at 560 WQM. I heard Lauren Green did have a little ding-a-ling. That's what, what's his name said?
Little Joe?
No, Haas. If you're a hoss, if you're a cow and you're on any kind of a low-carb diet, here's a wonderful store that you will absolutely love shopping in. And the reason I know that is because it'll be such a breath of fresh air. Because you go in a supermarket and they have nothing. I mean, they got the basics, the meat and the cheese and the that low-carb stuff, but that's it. Maybe they got a couple of things that's supposedly low-carb and you have nothing to snack on, no alternatives, nothing to keep you on your low-carb diet. Delights of West Boca is the number one low-carb store in the universe. They've got over 900 low-carb. In fact, I bet they got over 1,000 now, but Skippy refuses to give me a new copy because he's busy taking smelly BMs in the tea room there at QAM. Delights of West Boca is introducing great new stuff all the time. Be sure and check out the new low-carb instant cup of soup. Just add water, microwave, pop it in the old thing, a low-carb meal in a cup, 4 delicious flavors. Try the unbelievably delicious low-carb muffins for a quick breakfast. They've got all kinds of neat new things like the individual-sized cheesecake, low-carb hot cocoa, apple cider, blondies, and brownies, and their spectacular selection of low-carb pastas, sauces, dressing, chips, chocolates, the world-famous Carbolite ice cream, Judy's low-carb peanut brittle, and the Carborite ready-to-drink chocolate vanilla shakes. And now, thank goodness, the At Last brand chocolate crisp and chocolate mint bars with no maltitol, so you'll be satisfied and not wasting all day on the throne. Come in and try any products you like. You can try it before you buy it, and keep in mind that at Delights, all the Atkins brand's products are on sale all day, every day. Delights is open 10 to 10 every day. You'll find them on the northeast corner of Glades Road and 441 next to Boston Market in Boca. Call them at 1-877-LOW-CARB or shop them on the web at lowcarb.com. Don't forget, that's Delights of West Boca. It's your official Atkins Retail Center. Rest in peace.
Live and local, this is Sports Radio 560, QAQAM.
Yes, dude.
It's a great privilege to be here to outline a new budget. I throw darts at the board to come up with a number for tax relief. In my plan, no one will get relief. For lower-income families, you'll never get ahead. And this president doesn't care and won't pay. My attitude is government should stand in the way of families achieving their dreams. Together, we will do so. I hope you'll join me in standing firmly. Unrestrained. Some say my is too big. Others say it's too small. I respectfully disagree. This is just right.
Okay, so I'm watching CNN, and they're doing the thing again. They're about the hurricane. The tornado warning for Dade County.
Okay.
And so I click on to the Sun Sentinel and forget about it. And I click on to the Herald, and they got a big thing on their weather page, Hurricane Fabian. I'm looking all over the place. Where's the story? Where's the beef, you assholes? Here's Tropical Storm Henri, which is pretty ornery. And, here you go. Latest public advisories. You think it's going to be there? Statistics and warnings. Okay, well, this should be it. You have to, like, practically stand there. Don't you think that should be like a bulletin?
You'd think.
What the hell is wrong with these assholes? Let me just yank my thing over here. Let me pull it over. There's nothing on here. This is an advisory on a goddamn tropical storm. It has got nothing to do with any tornado warnings or anything else. You got to get it from CNN and the Herald and the Sun Sentinel. All you get is hemorrhoids when you wipe your ass with it. That's pretty damn classy. What a crock of crap. There's another reason South Florida cannot extricate itself from the state in which it finds itself, Florida. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. Don't forget, Miguel will be at the Coconut Creek Seminole Casino with your best of Neil stuff. That's 5550 Northwest 40th Street, just off Sample Road, west of the Turnpike. 3 to 5 this afternoon, and then tonight, 7 to 9 at the Hooters in Bayside. Stop by to win prizes. Enjoy a bucket of 5 Presidente beers for just $8.50. See how nicely I did that?
Very nice.
That was good. Just slid right in there. And Scott Ferrall will be at the Ole Ole on Los Olas Riverfront from 6 to 8 tonight. And he'll have some Dolphin tickets to give away. Some free crap for all you freeloaders. WQAM.
Hi, I wanted to ask you something about that music sharing. Maybe I'm overlooking the obvious.
Yes?
If you download music, I'm speaking hypothetically in case
right. Of course.
Your phone is
of
being,
course.
You know, all is being traced.
Because nobody would really do that, right?
No, that's against the law. But if you download a file from Kazaa or what have you, and as soon as it's downloaded, you stick it in another file, then how can they catch you? Isn't that obvious?
George?
I don't know. Or, like, what if you burn it to a CD and then erase the file you just downloaded and take it off your computer?
Sounds like a plan to me. I mean, it sounds like a concept, like a theory to me.
And throw your computer in the canal and buy a new one.
Right.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. Just have a busy weekend.
Yeah, I know.
All these illegal things that are going on. I'm so sick and tired of this fascist regime,
right.
Man.
I'd never do anything illegal.
I'm sick and tired of fascist and crazy right-wing religious nuts on the loose. Because that's the American effing freaking way.
So if I buy a CD and I let a friend listen to it,
yeah,
that file sharing?
Yes. Only if you loan them your nail file. Yeah, that's right. What if you loan somebody your nail file? They're going to, like, get you for that, too. It's file sharing. All you women out there and guys that file their nails. I can't stand guys that file their nails. You want to know why?
Why?
Because it means they have nails.
That's a good point.
I'm real nervous about guys that don't chew their fingernails.
I don't chew my fingernails.
Do you have fingernails?
I don't chew them. I cut them with clippers.
But you don't file them?
No.
Oh.
I defile them.
Thank goodness for that, because if you came on a year today and said that you filed your nails, I think that'd be the last straw, the last nail, so to speak, in your coffin. Man, talk about your image. WQAM. QAM.
How you
doing? Sounds like they're gargling over there. Well, too late, pal. You're too slow for me. WQAM, hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, on your rat situation, it's a simple thing. Decon makes their blue blocks. There's 8 blocks in a package. It costs you $4.50. And what happens is the rat eats it, and it takes 3 days. And what happens is they get thirsty. They go outside to go out and get water.
And when they drink, they blow up inside, right?
Yes, sir. The thing is, they don't drink in your house. They drink outside. And then if you're fortunate...
Yeah, probably the Krispy Critters people probably put a bowl of water up there for them in your attic.
Well, you know, the thing is I don't know if you really want to blame them for attracting stuff that comes inside, because what happens is when there's one rat, there's more than one, okay?
Right.
And I had 3 total. And 3 days later, I kid you not, I came home, and the 3 of them were going out after they had consumed the Decon Blue Block.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, man, my dog nailed every one of them, picked them up, and broke their necks, and then I got the rats out. And then,
all right.
So that's for $4.50. That's all you need.
But I don't understand. What do you put it in? I mean, just
no. It's a block. It just sits. If your roommate can go up and put it in the attic, that's fine. I put mine in the garage. What they do is they run along a trail, and you have to put it on the edge of the garage.
Yeah.
They don't go in the middle. They stay on the edge at night because they're
whiskers. Why is that?
Because their whiskers are their feelers, and they stay on the edge. So I put everything on the edge of the garage, and it worked out great.
Huh.
That's the key.
Anyway, well, let me ask you this. What if you put that stuff, like, outside?
No, because what will happen is another animal will come out and eat it.
Yeah.
And, you want to, if you have a garage and an attic, I don't know how your house is set up.
Yeah, I have a garage with a attic over it, and I also have the attic over the bedroom.
And the guy who called earlier about the air conditioner thing, they do go through the air conditioner. I got an air conditioner thing where they came in through from the outside, so he's right about that. And they take it, and they go up, they climb up and go into the attic. So if you can get it placed right by the air conditioner, I don't know what they call it. It's a metal thing, and the pipes, you can see the pipes going up.
Mm-hmm.
And but I tell you what, man, for $4.50, it got rid of my problem.
Okay, thanks, pal.
And you always have it. Well, now you're in the summertime, but I usually get it right before fall, because what they do is they're looking for someplace warm to go.
Maybe a block of ice up there couldn't be bad either.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Yes, sir. Bye.
See ya. Well, there you go. How about some blue blocker, man? Sounds good to me. A blue blocker for the old cocker? What?
Yeah.
No, I have read about that, where they chew the stuff and then they go outside and makes them very thirsty. When they drink it, blows up inside, and they just
They go outside unless they can get inside, in which case you'll find them dead in your toilet.
I'll find them dead in my toilet?
Well, yeah, they'll go for that water, and they'll go in there and get a drink, and they'll die in your toilet.
Well,
it's
what do you mean they'll go in there and get a drink? How are they going to get into my toilet?
Climb, claw, crawl.
From where? So in other words, you're telling me they're in the house?
They can't, if they can get in the house.
Now you're telling me they're in my freaking house?
The first thing I said is if they can get in there, they will.
Hopping around, having, what?
Yeah, check under the bed. Every night.
Sleep tight.
I don't have no rats here, okay?
Oh, no.
One more good reason not to be there. No rats in Toronto. Just SARS. And West Nile. Oh, that's right, you got plenty of West Nile there. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. Boy, we are rat intensive today.
Yes.
Perfect for QAM, by the way. WQAM. Hola. Nice talking to you. That must have been the Beaner boy. He just couldn't bring himself. Probably wants the job back, George. I want you to think about that.
About what?
Giving him just one more chance. Okay, time's up.
Thanks.
26 after 1. Don't forget, we got a tornado. Oh, there it is.
Excellent
tornado
news.
Tornado warning's over.
You will notice that we're seeing showers and thunderstorms extending south of Naples all the way out into the Gulf of Mexico.
Broward looks like one
this
big blob of rain.
All associated with tropical storm Henri, which continues to be a problem. Heavy rain and potential tornado.
The tropical storm Henri Richard, man, is just dumping it all over the state of Florida. Luckily, most of it is in places that we don't like anyway, like Tampa. Wow, in St. Pete, where all them 95-year-old assholes live?
So Miguel went to, what was it, weather.com?
And Temple Terrace, yes?
Yes.
And?
Canceled.
I just got through saying that.
We're reiterating.
I just got through saying that. The tornado warning is over. I have it right on CNN right here.
We'll have the latest on the former NBA pro.
Oh, no, there's Dennis Rodman with a wedding dress on. Oh, geez. And they also had a blurb on here before, which I tried to block out of my mind, speaking of blue blocker. I'm going to tell you, I might vomit if I actually verbalize this on the air. It showed a picture of Michael Jordan, and it said, Jordan coming back again? Do you think that the world can handle that? I think that the world will collapse if that man pulls that again. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, whatever.
I have one word for Michael Jordan, okay?
Retire!
Again. 26 after 1 at QAM. VIPSportsbook.com is the best in the business, man. Everybody on our radio station, including people under the age of 10 who couldn't gamble if their life depended on it, are peddling sportsbooks because everybody wants on the gravy train, you know. They want your money. But are you ever going to get it back? That's the question. 99% of those bookies are located in the jungles of Costa Rica. But VIPSportsbook.com is real class, the best in the business. They're the oldest and the largest sportsbook in the Netherlands. Just ask Joe Rose. I can't believe he's that illiterate. Well, he is. He's a good guy, but illiterate. In the Netherlands, 100% legal and licensed. Just listen to me and call VIPSportsbook.com. Don't listen to the dumb jocks. Pay attention to me. Call 1-866-VIP-BETS because VIPSportsbook.com is South Florida's best sportsbook. Sign up now and you can bet all year long. The South Florida football and basketball team is use-free. You want to bet the Dolphins? It's 100 to win 100. And after this Sunday, good luck to you. You want to bet the Hurricanes? It's 100 to win 100, so forget about the VIG. All signups get a 20% cash bonus, not some funny money match play bonus either. VIPSportsbook.com, that's how you find them online, or call them toll-free if you don't have, like, your PC. Call 1-866-VIP-BETS. That's 1-866-VIP-BETS. Tell me you heard all about it on QAM. VIPSportsbook.com, where you always are, the VIP.
Live and local, this is 560.
The radio's all yours now.
QAM.
Are you sure?
Hey, basketball fans. What could be better than watching your favorite players slam dunk? How about watching them get dunked in the slammer? You can with the all-new NBA Criminal League. Yes, all your favorite players on the court are now in court. There's Kobe Bryant, Darrell Armstrong, Damon Stoudemire, Glenn Robinson, Chris Webber, Jerry Stackhouse, and, of course, Allen Iverson.
Iverson shoots. And he scores!
When all the NBA superstars are in lockdown, the action is locked up. The NBA Criminal League.
I tell you, with this much talent, it's going to be awful tough to pick the MVP, the most violent prisoner. Oh, Vector.
They've gone from committing fouls to committing felonies. And you can be a material witness to all the drama with the NBA Criminal League.
See there, man? That's what I call a dead ball.
The NBA Criminal League.
I love these gangsters!
132 at 560 WQM. You want to hear the second race from Belmont?
Okay.
With the great Tom Durkin?
Is it too late to bet?
Oh, that's right. Let's call up VIPSportsbook.com and plunge our brains out. There's a six horse going in the gate. I think it's probably going to be Tom Durkin. It better be. It makes me look kind of stupid, you know? There's the seven going
waiting
in.
Waiting for Jugabug
it's not Tom Durkin. It's that other goofball. It's that guy that must be Marshall Cassidy's boyfriend.
Possible food and water contamination in Iraq.
No, you got to be kidding me. They just made that up. It's more that the liberal commie pinko propaganda. There's the eight horse going in. How many horses in this field, by the way, George?
About 30, man.
Isn't that great, though, that you can hear the no, you seriously,
the ambiance.
Like the hoofs on the turf, on the ground. And this eight doesn't want to go in the gate. You know, just, come on, push that bastard in there. See, that's what I hate about thoroughbred racing. Man, they kvitchy around before they can get him in the damn gate. And, you know, they don't want to go in there. You want to know why they don't want to go in there?
Why?
They want to go back to the barn, eat some hay, and just take a big dump. That's all.
Hey.
They don't want to go running around with some schmuck sitting on their back. Would you want to run around the track with some monkey sitting on your back?
No.
This eight horse ain't going in. So, like I said, Tom, or whoever you are calling the race, we don't have time. Taking three guys trying to push this poor little... Oh, look at that. He's reared up in the air. I love it. Don't you love it when they, like, throw the jockey about 100 yards? As long as he doesn't get hurt.
Oh, of course.
5670560. Steve, you've never been to the track in your life.
I've been to once each.
To Pompano Park.
Once, and Calder, and Gulfstream. One each.
But not to Hialeah.
No.
Well, why not? That's where all you people are supposed to go.
Short people.
Look at this. The jockey had to get off. Now they're going to try to load the 8 horse without the jockey. Forget about it. Are you kidding me? This horse don't want no part of this routine. WQAM.
Hey, good afternoon.
Yes, sir. Buenos to you. How you doing?
I'm out of work for the weekend. What could be better? Listen, I got to give you some credit about horse racing. You rekindled my interest in it, and it's something you haven't played in ages. And that
I don't have it.
Yeah,
you're talking about that Sunday Silence Easy Goer thing with Tom Durkin?
Absolutely correct, sir.
Tom Durkin. You hear him squeaking in the chair because it's right from the horse's ass? I don't have that.
Oh, man. He is the king, man.
He's phenomenal. And that's why I was going to put this on, because I just went to the Racing Channel. And
yeah.
And they're off. Number 8, Gold Flinger, unseated the rider.
How do you like that? At the start, this 8 horse that was acting up, he unseated the rider when he came out of the gate.
Key Roberta is out.
This guy's terrible, the one that does the races on the day when Tom is out snoozing.
Well, it's not a place for Major League talent, but I'm telling you, you used to play that call, I would get goosebumps, and yeah. I don't know how many times I heard it, and it had the same effect every time, so
Sunday Silence was one of my favorite horses. I love that. I don't know why, I just love that horse.
I like the horse and I like the name because that's one of the things I look forward to, Silence on Sundays.
Exactly.
Okay, so have a lovely weekend.
And you too, thanks. Thanks, Pally. That 8 horse threw it around. How do you like that? Wasn't that a propitious moment to be looking at that thing?
I'd
better turn it off.
Wish I'd seen it.
I would have better wipe off my propitia. We got 145 votes for OJ, man. He is all alone. There ain't nobody near him. If you could boot one person out of South Florida, who would it be? OJ's got 145 votes, and that's out of 432. I mean, he's off to the races. Mo Howard David, though, is head-to-head, nose-to-nose, speaking of horse races, with Ann Coulter. Mo's got 64, and Ann's got 63. Maybe we can make a package deal on Greyhound Bus. Alex Pinga Pequeña, 31. Miriam Elephant, 24. H. Wayne Hypinga, 18. Out of sight, out of mind. There was a time when he would have been maybe right up there on OJ's ass, you know?
Showed up.
But nobody, he's small potatoes now. Jose Consucco, 17. Reverend James Kennedy, 16. Rick Sanchez, only 16. Now, that's pretty surprising, you know what? He's been on there long enough now to be up there on the leaderboard.
I'm shocked and dismayed.
On the leaderhosen. Maris Grecias has got 10. Miss Matt Fudge has got only 7. Gloria Estefan, 7. That's a good match. Kenneth Masmacho, Matt Fudge, or Gloria Estefan. No contest. Jay Fiedler's got 5. Spilkey's Nerey's 3. Jeff Rimmer got a pair, Mickey Arison won, and Dwight Lauderdale's got 1. Somebody out there had to stick it to poor Dwight. WQAM.
Break your neck.
You know, it's interesting, but line 6, it's always him. How does he do that?
It's the magic line.
Is that the magic line? WQAM.
Neil, I got someone for your poll.
Yes?
Ike Siemens.
What Ike an Siemens? Asshole. He is an old asshole. I will put him on there, but he's so pathetic. I mean, you know, I don't think he could handle it. I think just a trip up to the state line, that would be the end of him. So let's do it.
He'll get some damn votes.
Okay.
Thank you.
You got it. Ike Siemens, fuddy duddy old Ike Siemens, who's always sucking around, sucking Mickey Arison's ass, and always says, oh, you're an idiot, Ike. The fact that they keep, you know, dusting off the mothballs and dragging him out of the broom closet is so sad on NBC6, you know? Joe Rose says they ought to send him to the nether world. That's what he said. Joe isn't quite sure where that is, but the Netherlands. Come on, Joe. What is it? I mean, I know the Meadowlands. You know that.
Yeah.
But not the Netherlands. Joe needs to get out a little bit more. See, the only problem is he has a tough time at customs with that big head. A lot of times they tell him to check it.
Well, you could smuggle a lot in there.
Oh, you would just imagine? Wow. Just inside the left ear. WQAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, are you still doing the poll for who? Still want to get fired from
QAM. Go ahead. Give us a suggestion. I thought we already finished that, but go ahead.
Front desk. That guy's a fag, man.
Who is it?
What a giveaway.
Oh, Carlos, yeah. Freaky Carlos. Now, he must have all the naked pictures of Greg with Screw Ann and with Phyllis and with certain other ones. He must have those naked pictures from over the years. What other reason could they? Or maybe he's got the pictures of Kid Curry and Anna Squeak. Those intimate pictures.
An album.
5-6-7, maybe he's got the pictures of Joe Costello and, what's her name?
What's her
Close
name?
Personal friend, Bo Griffin. in that fist fight. Oh, that! I'm so sorry I missed that. That's one of the few things that I feel I really missed out on by not being there most of the time, which usually delights me.
Well, I wasn't in the room, but I wish I had been.
Who the hell are you? And who are you talking to?
She was some piece of work. By the way, we ought to talk about her a little bit, you know, about Bo. But
okay.
I guess not.
Why
no,
not?
We better not.
All right.
No, she's the kind of broad that'll come back and, you know, like start suing everybody. She's just,
yeah, you're
just
right.
just that butch. 21 till 2 at 560 WQM. 2 o'clock means the Jim Mad Dog Mandate Show.
All right.
They'll be in rare form today because the regular season, now all the foreplay, it's gone. All those meaningless exhibition games, and I know he said and everybody else says, we'll be glad when it's over, and it is. It's done. Finito, baby. Now the real guys, the real men, will put on the jock straps, except, of course, the Dolphin game because they're playing a girls' team. So it'll be the real Dolphins against the real little girls, Houston on Sunday. But he's all whipped up and fired up, and the only thing, of course, he's wishing is that Bill Zimfer would come back.
We're Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Oh, and the voice of the Toronto Maple Leafs, and you're listening to the Hockey Authority, Neil Gott.
560 WQAM presents the Joe and Bo Show, starring Joe Costello and Bo Griffin. Indeed, call 567-0560. Mobile users dial pound 560. To fax Joe and Bo, call 305-650-0198. Now, here's Joe and Bo.
Well, I never thought I'd find the kind of ride that I've been tooling around in today.
Wait,
now it's a classic
wait,
set of
hold
wheels.
On now. What do you think you do?
What do you think you do?
Leave it alone. What are you doing?
What do you mean by playing that?
We play it all the time.
Ooh, I don't want to hear no whitehead doing nigger bashing.
You said it, I didn't.
Say what?
I said, you said that word, not me. I never
you
said it.
You be playing it. That be close enough for me.
What is your problem?
My problem be you. You white honky guinea bastard, you. Now, don't you be looking at me.
Don't you be looking at me, honey.
Don't look at me.
Don't you
no,
look at me.
No, you just never got over Cleo stealing your gig.
What'd you say?
You heard me.
What'd you say?
I said...
You know who I am?
Oh,
I am the great... Bo Griffin! I'll have you know, I carry a lot of weight around here.
Yeah, you carry it around here, and around here, and around
ooh.
Here.
Ooh. Ow! I want your white, honky ass fire!
Go ahead and try.
Dolph! Gray! Get your white asses in here! Right now!
Okay.
Right now!
Explain what's going on.
First, he takes the last roast beef sandwich in the lunchroom.
Uh-huh.
Then, he starts ripping my black ass on the air!
All right.
I'm gonna kill
down.
You all!
Just calm down.
I'm gonna kill
we all
everybody. Stand back! Stand back!
Well, be careful with that.
Light it up in your white ass!
.145 Maybe Bo is spending her spare time in the Netherlands. She'd probably have a good time over there, you know, with all those.
Yeah. What?
Anyway, Jane, one of our regular faxers in Fort Lauderdale says it's a story about a rat, but I don't really understand it. Well, I mean, I do understand it, but at the end there's a sentence here about rats are one of the few animals love humans and have benefited from humans screwing up the planet.
Oh yeah.
Do you understand that?
Absolutely. They have thrived because of us.
Oh, I see. They love humans because they benefited from us. Whatever. Okay, thank you, Jane. It's a story about her mom finding a rat coming up the old toilet, up the old bowl.
Yeah.
567-0580. I don't want to hear about that no more, okay? No more rat stories. Grosses me out. Mouse, don't bother me. I know, in fact, Troy Stratford was telling me, speaking of Troy the boy, he was saying to me, even like a little mouse, he gets all freaked out. Now that's pretty, you gotta be a real pussy. I think folks get freaked out by rodents, you know what?
And spiders and snakes.
All of these things. 153 votes for OJ. Too bad all of those things didn't cross the path of Nicole and Ron that night and chase his awful murdering ass away. They'd still be here today, maybe. OJ 153 and Colder 67. Boy, they despise that bitch, and rightfully so. Right-wing slut. Howard David at 66 continues following right with his nose on her ass. Alex Pinga Pequena, 33. Marion Elephant, 26. Wayne Hypinga, 20. Reverend Kennedy's moved into a double digits, 18. Jose Consucco, 17. Ricky Tiki Sanchez, out of sight, out of mind, 17. And also in double digits, Gloria Stefan and Maris Grecias, 11. I'd like to see the two of them together in a menage a deux. WQAM, the bizarre line. Hello.
Hello, Neil?
Yes, sir.
This is John Cagle, and I was just wondering if you were talking about plasma TVs a little earlier. And I was wondering if anybody out there knows what the deal is with eBay on those plasmas. You can negotiate a plasma TV from $2,000 for the same thing that cost $10,000 in the stores.
Right.
And it's free shipping, and they pay the it's all warrantied and everything.
Hmm.
And I was negotiating with two of them, one with a 50-inch Sony and one with...
In other words, you were bidding on it on eBay.
No, I wasn't bidding. I was going to buy it outright.
Oh, I see.
And it was $2,000 for the Pioneer, and the same exact thing sells for $9,000 over at Sears.
Wow.
And the same thing with a 50-inch Sony television. And I was just wondering if that's a rip-off or what.
It fell off the truck.
Pardon me?
Scratch and dent sale.
No, they say it's brand new, in the box, never opened.
Well, I'll tell you what, you test it out, and we'll let us know how you make out.
Well, I'm going to, I don't know. The other problem is you negotiate with them, and they're both of them, the two that I negotiated with,
yeah.
One is in Italy, and one is in Germany.
Like I said, forget about it. Remember those three famous words, forget about it.
The other thing that I wanted to tell you, years ago in 1997, you're the responsible for me driving my Corvette. I listened to
All
you.
All right.
Excellent. Magnificent choice.
And back in 97, you were talking about him. I was ready to get rid of my little Cadillac that I had. And I went out and I bought one up in Sanford, Florida. I still have it. It's brand new, sitting in my garage.
Greatest thing ever invented.
And I love it. You still
okay,
have
enjoy, Pally. Have a great weekend.
Thank you.
Thanks. Don't do that eBay thing. You're coming from Germany and from Italy. Well, they'd arrive, you know, piece by piece.
Right. It's been good. It's good.
Sooner or later. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. Big sports weekend coming up, man. Wow, can you smell the pressure or what? Especially on this radio station, man, where we're not just into it, we're obsessed with
sports.
I want to blame Clarence for that whole Scott Jr. episode. I don't want to get out of here for the weekend before I really just rip him an ass.
Okay.
No, seriously, it's his fault. I mean, it's nice that he gets my paycheck on time, since that's the only reason I'm really here, but...
We just needed somebody.
You know, but he's not. He's just let it ride. You know, and it's not satisfactory. It's unacceptable.
In this place, really, to let somebody just.
He has dropped
work?
The balls. That's what the B said. He dropped the balls right on the floor. Not good, Clarence. Butch up a little bit, sweetheart. I know in your case it ain't easy, but give it a shot.
Dickie.
WQAM.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Respond to the guy about the eBay TV.
Right.
Chances are it's a PAL TV.
It's a what?
PAL as opposed to NCS.
Oh, that's right. It's the PAL format because it's in the year. That's a good point, and he won't be able to watch it.
There you go.
Thanks, Pally. What the hell he's saying? He's like, you're breaking up. Probably got a PAL phone. I didn't know there was such a thing as a PAL format TV. Now, I had that beautiful TV, that low TV in Amsterdam. Boy, that's a great set.
Yeah.
But I didn't know that the TVs are like in that format. I know that the VCRs are. Huh?
I don't know anything about it.
Yeah, you do, because you know that I have a VCR that's like both. It goes both ways, AC
right.
and DC.
No,
so
but
to
I mean,
speak.
Like you, I didn't know if the TVs were
I don't know. I really don't know. But at any rate, it'll probably be in about 100 pieces. In other words, don't do it. We're begging you. Don't do it, Pally. You're a young guy. You got your whole life ahead of you.
Live and local. This is Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Friday, you bastard.
First, it was a hit on MTV, then a number one movie. Now, it's coming to Broadway. It's Jackass, the musical, starring Johnny Knoxville.
Well, hello, Johnny, spread your cheeks. Johnny, it's so fun to punch you right there in the gooch.
Yes, all those risky stunts have been combined with fabulous show tunes to create Jackass, the musical.
Wow, the music, the dancing, the guy eating a yellow snow cone, it was better than Cats.
76 dumb guys passed.
musical, with all your favorite jackasses on stage singing torch songs, then setting their hair on fire with them.
I'm Steve-O, I'm Steve-O, I'm just freaking loco, I'm hurting myself today.
The Great White Way has just turned black and blue, thanks to Jackass the Musical.
155 at 560 WQM. You'll be amazed when I announce to you,
okay,
that I am fully clothed.
Well,
I have on my shirt, my pantaloonies, my socks, my shoes. My hair is brushed neatly. I have all of my spritzes under my arm, on my puss.
Good. Thanks for not telling us
sooner
that you work.
And for me, I look good considering the best that I can do. Huh?
Yeah.
In other words, when it comes 2 o'clock, I'm ready to fly out that door. Not any special reason, you understand. I'm just ready to fly out that door. In fact, you'll be able to hear me singing all the way down there.
I am Celia Cruz and I am dead now, but I remember when I was alive.
And you know something? So now they're ringing my phone right now. Can you hear it?
Hold the phone up.
Real comedians, man. Trust me when I tell you.
I am Celia Cruz and I am dead now.
Okay, just calm down. Back in the box. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon wireless line. WQAM.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Pretty good.
Well, got to kind of call for a while. You're being set up, my friend, as a repeat customer. Here's how it's supposed to work. When you're
I can barely hear this caller, Miguel.
How about now?
Much better.
All right. You're being set up a little bit. It's called a repetitive business. The way it's supposed to work, when they come to your inspection, you're supposed to go up there and look for the droppings and a black light and look for the urine track, seal your house, then they can use the peanut butter in the traps. When they put the peanut butter in the traps first, right, and attracts them, then they'll seal your house, and then they'll catch the ones that are in there, but then they're going to find their way back in there because they know where that peanut butter was. And you're going to have to call them back again and do the thing over and over again.
How are they going to get back in there if they really seal it upright?
They'll find a way. They'll dig holes right through your concrete. They go through concrete, and what they do is they seal your house with that foaming agent, like that one caller said.
Yeah.
And they'll eventually eat right through that. They want to get in, they'll eat right through that. They'll eat through the insulation, do the air conditioning up, and travel their way right back to where they knew that smell was.
I think it's time to call in the rat patrol myself.
Second, for your poll, I've been trying to get through to you. I don't know his name. I think it's Raul, you know? Who is that Cuban attorney out of Miami who caused all those problems with the green tea, you know,
Ramon
people?
Saul Sanchez.
Ramon, yeah. Saul Sanchez.
He needs to get back out of South Florida.
Yeah, he needs to get back to those beautiful hotels in Havana.
And for your poll, Jose Canseco lives in Tampa. His wife and kid's daughter lives in Miami. He only visits.
Yeah, he's got a house there, though.
Yeah, his wife has a house there.
And he's constantly in jail there. But, okay, have a great day, pal. We'll get him out. When in doubt, throw him out. And he's got a street named after him somewhere in Miami Lakes or someplace.
In front of Coral
Some
Park.
Some big place. It's where?
In front of Coral Park High School.
Well, I'll be damned. Isn't that embarrassing? What a great role model for the kids there at Coral Park High School. Wow. Although, of course, if they ever get in any trouble, he can always protect him with his piece. 5670560 pound. That thing with a guy talking about the rat skin bag, that didn't sound too promising, did it?
No. I know what he was talking about. They need to seal your house first, then they put the bait and
Did you say
on
Celia?
I am Celia Cruz and I
seal
am
Seal your house.
Now.
Oh, Celia House. I know Celia Cruz, but I don't know Celia House.
Oh, she has some hits.
Yeah. Now, what were you going to say? It's very important, and I'm sorry.
No, that he
Celia
made a good
Cruz
point that I hadn't thought of before. If you don't seal the house up first and then put the traps on there, then you have the situation that you have right now, that you're just drawing in rats from the hood, like you've been saying.
Yeah, but he's saying that even, in other words, afterward, once they put the peanut butter in, they're going to smell it? Even after they take the traps out?
Well,
is that possible?
Yeah, it's possible.
Or they're going to remember where the peanut butter was? I don't think they're that smart.
That's
okay,
why
they
I
may
defer,
be a little smarter than most of our salespeople.
I prefer to defer to experts.
Do you mean the experts that are, like, charging me per rat that they catch?
No, the ones that don't.
Oh, well, in other words, our friends at ATM. Hey, listen, I have no problem with that. I think they're the best. I think they're great ATM.
Friend Steve,
alternative termite management and pest control.
Never let me down.
Well, I'm giving one more chance because today is the day. It's supposed to be Celia cruising my house. And just really locking everything up real, real tight, okay? I mean, I don't want to play Butch Boss, and I haven't mentioned him on the air before. Or maybe I did just in passing.
Yeah,
I was calling Crispy Critter, which isn't their real name anyway. Yes. Crispy Critters. I do like that. I'd like to see all those critters crispy. Probably some people in my hood would like to have them for lunch. And you can have them No charge.
Thank you.
Okay, well, we'll see. Monday, we'll give you a report and find out what the hell happens in my attic. Jesus, God almighty. It's always something in Florida, man. If it ain't the bufo toads, it's the rats. Right?
Right.
I mean, so we got a little mad cow up here, and we had a little SARS problem and a little West Nile virus, and then we had the tainted beef, and we have, the electric, the power outage, you know? There's no place to run, no place to hide. You know what I'm talking about?
No, what are you talking about?
I'm talking about there ain't no real paradise. The Mad Dog's coming along next, 2 to 4. He's going to be whipped up into a frenzy in anticipation of this season starting on Sunday, and, of course, in anticipation of having to work with the Mo-Meister. The Humper from the Crystal Palace in Bahamas at 4.
Bye, bye, bye!
The Neil Rogers Show on 560 WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
Dickie.
Absolutely.